Stadium in the capital city of Charleston, West Virginia. We welcome you to the Friday Night Football Game of the Week presented by the West Virginia Federal Credit Union. Tonight, it's the 2-0 Capital Cougars, the defending Class AAA state champions, against the 2-0 Cabell Midland Knights. Great to have you with us on this third weekend of the West Virginia high school football season of 2015 with Tom Hunter, Joe Stevens on the field, and Mark Martin. Great to have you here. And Tom, here we are. A week ago, we had a battle of 1-0 teams. This week, 2-0 teams. This is going to be a great matchup because last year it was Cabell Midland's lone loss of the regular season as Capital rolled through most opposition and won the state title.
Yeah, and Cabell Midland had opportunities, Mark, as we recall, in the fourth quarter of that game last year with Capital down at Cabell Midland's Knights Stadium to try to take the Cougars to the woodshed. They couldn't quite put them away, and we know the rest of the story. Tyree Pratt showed up and had an outstanding fourth quarter to lead the Cougars to the victory. Hasn't missed a beat, looked great last week in a win over a tough South Charleston ball club here on the web game of the week. Put up numbers, 156 passing yards, two touchdowns, eight of 12 passing on the night, the two big catches by Chunky Bays. And, of course, Silas Nazario, while he was held silent a lot of the first half, came through late, great with the ball control offense for John Carpenter to lead the Cougars out of there with a win.
Cabell Midland has yet to be tested this season. They put up some impressive numbers.
The Knights so far in two games this season, 97 points they have put on the scoreboard with this high-powered offense that you would think would be missing some weapons after the graduation of Coy Pettit and Alex Childers, but they certainly haven't missed a beat in filling those positions with Jacob Hendricks, who's having an outstanding first couple weeks of the season out of the backfield. But really kind of the unsung element in this offense is the throwback halfback in Caperton Humphrey. John Carpenter says he truly is a throwback type of player. They have a lot of options with Humphrey in that backfield. If they need to go option with him, they can do that. He's a great blocker. Certainly does open up some opportunities for that Midland offense.
All right, look forward to it, Tom. 2-0 Capital, 2-0 Cabell Midland. We will be back with more pregame coverage in just a moment here on WCHSTV.com.
You'll score big when you give West Virginia Federal Credit Union the opportunity to earn your business. West Virginia Federal Credit Union is your community credit union with the goal of building deposit and loan relationships, not just opening accounts. They offer the highest level of service for every member every day and feature a no annual fee debit card that offers cash rewards and surcharge-free ATM access at over 50 locations in the Charleston-Huntington area. It's time to get on the team that has the best game plan. West Virginia Federal Credit Union. Together we all win.
No matter what you're looking for, Thornhill Auto Group does it best. Thornhill GM Superstore Corridor G, Chapmanville. Thornhill Ford Lincoln Corridor G, Chapmanville. Thornhill Factory Outlet of Logan, Fountain Place Mall. Thornhill Acura, South Charleston. Thornhill Mitsubishi Corridor G, Chapmanville. Thornhill Factory Outlet of South Charleston. And Thornhill Commercial Solutions. Thornhill Auto Group. Visit online. www.thornhillautomotive.com.
Yes, sir.
My old phone company internet was
slow,
frustrating,
unreliable,
exhausting,
constant Netflix buffering,
spinning wheel of death.
You can never get back that minute.
We switched to Suddenlink and it was like
I love it.
Life-changing.
Suddenlink lets you connect to everything you love faster and easier. Get the fastest internet in town for less. Suddenlink, more power to you. Get HD TV plus 75 meg broadband internet for just $69 a month.
Back live at UC Stadium, Capital and Cabell Midland getting set to battle. 2-0 teams set to square off. Joe Stevens standing by with the head coach of the Capital Cougars, John Carpenter. Good evening, Joe.
Good evening, Mark. Coach, 2-0, ranked number one in the state. Tough opponent tonight, Cabell Midland.
Yeah, that's why you want to play. You want to play people that are good, and they're pretty good, and we're excited for it.
Coach, with this type of game this early in the season, you had a tough one last week against South Charleston, came out victorious. How is this a good test for the team this early?
Oh, anytime you play Cabell Midland, it's a good test, early or late. And knowing we're probably going to see one of those two when the weather turns cold. So, but, you know, it's a good test for us. And like I say, that's the reason we've lifted all those weights and done all that running. So they're excited and ready to play.
Go get them, Coach.
Appreciate it.
Thank you. Coach John Carpenter of the Capital Cougars, Mark.
All right, thank you very much, Joe Stevens. Look forward to your reports tonight, and we certainly, as always, thank John Carpenter for his time there prior to tonight's kickoff. It's been an interesting series as of late, Tom, dating back to 2006. Capitals won 7 of 9, 4 of 5. They've scored 35 the last 2 years against the Knights as the defending AAA state champs come onto the field here at UC Stadium.
Yeah, and 6 of those last 10 contests, Mark, decided by 7 points or less. We don't expect anything different here tonight. Two very evenly matched powerhouses in Class AAA football in the state of West Virginia meeting tonight at Lakely Field, UC Stadium.
The officials for tonight's game, Doug Spry is the referee, Jim Shedd is the umpire, Steve Grayley the linesman, Mark Akers is the line judge, Chris Chafin is the back judge, and Jim Levy is the field judge, and they wear those black armbands in memory of a former referee here in the Valley, Greg Wyatt. We've witnessed that the last 3 games. I thought a lot of that gentleman.
Greg Wyatt very well thought of in this officiating fraternity in the Kanawha Valley and throughout the state, and so many of these officials, you know, within the chapters, very tight-knit, close relationships. As you see crews, it's not uncommon, Mark, to see crews work 20, 25, 30 years together with just some rotations here and there through the years, but pretty much that same core group and a very close-knit fraternity remembering one of their own.
Cabell Midland will go on offense first, and the Knights 41-6 winners over Spring Valley to start the season, and then 56-6 last week against Winfield. Cabell Midland in the all-white tonight, and Capital in the blue. And Tyler Schaefer will kick it off for the Cougars, and quite simply, John Carpenter says he's one of the best around when it comes to kickoffs.
Beautiful night for football in the capital city. Glad you could join us online at WCHSTV.com for our WCHS Friday Night Football Extra Web Game of the Week, week number 3, as we get ready to tee it up and kick it off. Capital and Cabell Midland.
Humphrey is back deep. Caperton Humphrey, outstanding senior, along with Devin Stapleton. Schaefer puts the left foot into it, and we're underway here at UC Stadium. Stapleton out across the 10, the 15, the 20, and finally wrestled from behind by Devon Atkins, the outstanding linebacker for Capital, and does a nice job there on the kickoff. So the Knights will take over here. It scored 36 points in the first quarter a week ago against Winfield. Tyler Brown is their quarterback, a 5'10", 170-pound senior, first-year starter, but as Luke Salmon says, he's not your typical first-year starter. He's put a lot of work in to leading this offense. It was interesting. They opened the season against Spring Valley, who had enjoyed the luxury of a great quarterback by the name of Tyler Brown, and Spring Valley had to watch Cabell Midland come to town with a quarterback named Tyler Brown. Right out of the gate, we have an offsides defensively against the Cougars.
And Mark, the Cougars defensively, you know, last week, outstanding second half performance, and you look anchored up front by Brown and Peyton, and in the middle by Etheridge and Atkins there, and those middle and those Sam linebacker positions.
And it's an outstanding defense. Brown turns and gives to Stapleton, and Stapleton will go for maybe a couple. Stapleton coming into the contest, 17 carries, 102 yards, 3 touchdowns. Cabell Midland's offense scored on its first 7 possessions a week ago. Stapleton grew up as running back, and Luke Salmon says you just can't believe some of the runs he's made already this season. Going to line him up as a standing wing on the near side, and they'll go to Humphrey, and Humphrey hammers forward for a few to the 35, give him 2 on the play.
Humphrey, 1,000-yard rusher, Mark, last season, and Luke Salmon says he's done nothing but bulk up. He's gotten maybe a little bit quicker in the offseason. He was already one of the quickest guys on this Midland squad. And again, he's the X factor in this offense. Certainly gives him an opportunity to mix things up.
67 yards in the opener against Spring Valley, 43 last week against Winfield. 3rd and short here for the Knights. They will give it to Stapleton. He will try to swing it wide to the far side and does so, driven out of bounds, but not before he gets the first down. They'll spot him out at the 37-yard line, so it's a first down. Moving the chains, presented by the West Virginia Oil and Gas Association, celebrating 100 years.
Stapleton with a nice piece of running there, working the sideline, taking advantage of some valuable real estate. Worked a couple steps beyond the stake, seeing he was going to be able to get the first down.
Tanner Mullins, the tight end, shifting, comes to the near side. Humphrey heads his way up over the 45-yard line to the 46-yard line. Dorian Etheridge there to make the stop for the Cougars. Gain of 8 on the play brings up second down and 2 for Caperton Humphrey, 6'2", 195, a senior. Tom mentioned over 1,000 yards a year ago, 1,341, 13 touchdowns. Again, Cabell Midland 9-1 during the regular season. Lone loss 35-28 to the Cougars. They lost in the second round of the playoffs to arch rival Huntington in what was a second meeting of the season between the two. Humphrey again getting the call, close to the first down marker. Bring up third down and 1.
Officials conferring, looking at the spot, seeing if they're going to move the chains here without a measurement. They're going to take time to bring the chains on for a measurement.
Capital defense in the opener against Riverside held the Warriors to 59 net yards, 0 for 3 passing. Stretch the chains here and see if we've got a first down, and boy, just got it.
Another fine piece of running by Humphrey out of that backfield. Jacob Hendricks with 168 yards on 8 carries, leading that backfield rotation coming into the night's game. Of course, Stapleton 167 on the year of rushing with 4 touchdowns, and Humphrey's 130 with a touchdown. A solid stable of backs for the Knights out of Ona.
Up front is Jordan King, the strong tackle on the left side, the strong guard Briar Ellswick. Both are sophomores. A lot of potential. Lucas Jacobs is the center. He's a senior college player in Luke Sammons' mind. And here's one that goes straight ahead on the handoff. And Humphrey again, the horse up near midfield. The right guard is Hunter Hicks, a junior. And the right tackle is Tanner Sweeney. Again, Tanner Mullins is the tight end. 2-yard pickup there.
Mac Payton was the Capital Cougar in on that tackle. We hit on a lot of stops last week for this Capital defensive line in the win over South Charleston.
And Tyler Brown got drilled by Devon Atkins as he handed that football off. And again, it was Humphrey getting the call. So the football right at midfield, third down and 8 for the Knights. Third straight road game for Cabell Midland, and Capital home for the second time this season. Luke Salmon says, hey, I kind of like going on the road. You just have to focus on the game. No distractions there when you're playing on campus, though they do love that home field setting there in Ona. Third and 8. Brown pitching to Stapleton, trying to swing it wide and nothing doing. Going to lose a couple. Job there by that Cougar defensive attack, and Max Shavers, the corner, coming over there and getting a lot of help, and it's going to be a punting situation for Cabell Midland, and Caperton Humphrey will step back and punt it. First game, 2 punts for 32 yards. A week ago, 4 punts for an average of just over 28. Silas Nazario will stand back deep for the Cougars at the 19. Humphrey at his 38. Left footer, and this one up high, and going to drop and hit, and Stapleton giving chase, and that one is going to roll inside and be downed at the 8-yard line. Well, it didn't look pretty at first. It was just a high kick, but boy, great bounce, and there you go. That's where Capital will begin operation for the first time tonight offensively, with 7:04 to go here in this opening quarter of play. Great to have you with us here on the Friday night football game of the week presented by the West Virginia Federal Credit Union on WCHSTV.com.
Net of about 43 yards on the kick, and certainly where Cabell Midland wanted to force Capital to start out field position-wise as the Cougars working deep in their own territory inside their own 10 to start off this drive as we see Tyree Pratt on offense for the first series of the evening here for the Cougars.
Trips wide to the bottom of your screen for Tyree Pratt, the outstanding senior quarterback, off to WVU when his career here at Capital comes to an end, and looking to throw on first down, rolling, firing, and overshoots his intended receiver there, Quade McNabb, number 13, 6'2", 165-pound senior, tall kid, a kid they certainly counting on to replace the outstanding Jordan Kinney, who was the MVP of the Super 6 a year ago when they won the AAA title, caught 33 passes a year ago, now playing college basketball. So second and 10 for Pratt and the Cougars. Pratt hands to Nazario, turning the corner, and Nazario has first down yardage. Taken out there at the 20, so it's a gain of 12, and tackle made on the far side of the field by Reese Donahue. Alex Ray also there as well.
Coming out of that cornerback slot to come over to seal, but Nazario getting to the outside corner and doing what he does best when he can get to the corner and get some space, creating good opportunities in the running game for the Capital Cougars.
Nazario now over 100 yards for the season. Pratt firing, catch made, crunchy Bays, and then Bays taken to the turf by Stapleton. Crunchy Bays with the two touchdown catches a week ago. Coming into the contest, 10 catches, 190 yards, three touchdowns. There is Devin Stapleton getting work on both sides of the ball. Luke Sammons does not play a lot of guys both ways.
Stapleton, an all MSAC selection on defense for the Knights last season.
Second down eight. Pratt in trouble, weaving his way around, and Pratt finally slips down at the 21. Dustin Bauck, the bandit linebacker there to make sure he's down. That brings up third down and nine. Loses one on the play.
And you look at that Midland defensive unit, and there's a lot of depth there for Luke Sammons up front. He could rotate about nine kids in that rotation, so always keeping fresh bodies up on that defensive front for rush pressure for this Knights defense.
Three receivers go wide to the top of your screen, two at the bottom. Pratt in trouble, fires down the field and in and out of the hands of Nazario. Will bring up a fourth down for Capital.
And we see it again, similar to last week, Mark. We've talked about the challenges that Pratt has had when defensive fronts bring some pressure and bring some blitzes. Cabell Midland not completely selling out on that first series, playing pretty smart containment defense, but certainly some opportunities there to put a little bit of heat on the experienced senior quarterback for the Cougars.
Devon Atkins is the punter. Ball hits, and the Knights are going to get away from it, and it will be downed at the 44-yard line. So no score here in the opening quarter of play. Cabell Midland 2-0, Capital 2-0. Great battle of two outstanding West Virginia high school football programs here at one of the great venues, UC Stadium. We'll look at the home side here. New lights here, Tom Hunter.
You can see a difference if you're here, maybe not on the web stream as much, but it is much brighter on the visiting sideline. Work along the Piedmont Road visiting section completed this week. They'll be working on the home side next week. Certainly a huge difference in the lighting. I'm sure they still got to fine tune and get them pointed in the right direction here, but certainly a huge upgrade for Lately Field.
Knights take over with the football. Brown wanting to throw and tosses it out. Catch made by Humphrey. First down yardage as he zooms into Capital territory.
And again, now that fullback position, he can do it all. He can run the option. He can give you blocking to open up holes for your tailback. And he can get outside on the corner and catch a ball and get upfield. He did an outstanding job there. First down for the Knights.
16-yard gain. Stapleton. And he is wrapped up there. Well, they got him around the ankle there as he tried to get through the blue wall there. Wayne Etheridge leading the charge. And Mark Mason and company there on the sideline. Fred Myers, the defensive coordinator, up here beside of us. Great view of this game. Give Stapleton a gain of one. Brown, quick handoff. Humphrey, straight ahead. Right behind the center, who is Lucas Jacobs. Jacobs' father, Mitch, head volleyball coach at Marshall.
Devon Atkins had time on that defensive line mark, another outstanding effort as he dropped a shoulder and was able to stop that run close to the line of scrimmage.
Just a gain of one. The ball resting at the 38. Third and eight. Stapleton goes in motion. Humphrey. Nice fake to Humphrey, and Brown keeps it and then pitches to Stapleton. And Devin Stapleton takes it to the 33-yard line, driven out of bounds there by Capitals' Quade McNabb. Fourth and three from the 33. We got the air horns out tonight. Brown turns, Humphrey driving those strong legs forward, and we'll have the first down.
Push it about a half yard past the end chain there to keep the drive rolling for the Knights. Great second effort as he got bunched up at the line and just continued to drive with his feet. Pushing forward for Cabell Midland's first down. This offensive line, Luke Salmon's Mark very pleased so far with what he's seen out of this young offensive line. They typically will run a rotation of three to four new kids each year, but very pleased with what he's seen.
Here's Brown. May have been a bad exchange there, so Brown just keeps it and should be back to the line of scrimmage, which is the 30-yard line. So we'll bring up second down and 10. He says it may not be as big of a line as they had a year ago, but he's very pleased with it. And somewhat like what John Carpenter is experiencing now, he's got the starters that are now seniors who've been there a while, and Luke Salmon's now with a couple of sophomores there that he's going to enjoy the luxury of having for seasons to come.
Flag on the field.
Going to have procedure penalty against the Knights.
Some movement up on that offensive line, and now that umpire's position, the flag comes, marks it back five for Cabell Midland, second down and 15. As we close in on the 2-minute mark here in the opening quarter, scoreless and lately between the Capital Cougars and Cabell Midland Knights.
Brown under center. Fakes the handoff, the lefty, airing it out, looking for Hendricks, who had the coverage beat, but Brown overshoots his intended receiver, Jacob Hendricks, and that will bring up third down and 15. Well, again, Coach Sammons, he likes this quarterback. He likes what he can do throwing the ball. Again, they're going to, with backs like Humphrey and Stapleton, they're not going to throw it a lot, but they can. There you see Luke Sammons, head coach for Cabell Midland, Ravenswood High graduate, 1999, two-time All-Stater, Hunt Award winner, three-year starter at Marshall, played in three bowl games. Get more into his resume as the evening goes on. Ball at the 35, third and 15. Straight ahead they go to Humphrey, who was bottled up there and stop made by Mac Payton, the defensive end. So it's fourth down now. Call it fourth and 13.
Mark, a great early season atmosphere here at Langley Field.
Love those air horns.
The air horns, the Capital Cougar Band, one of the outstanding marching bands, two of the outstanding marching bands here tonight with the Cabell Midland Marching Knights as well.
All right, fourth and 13 from the 33. Brown looks over at the sidelines. Turn, they hand it off to Stapleton, and he's to the 30-yard line, and that's where they will stop him, and Cabell Midland will turn it over on downs. 3-yard pickup there by Stapleton, but well short of the first down. Gonna get a look at that crowd here tonight.
You hear that Capital crowd roaring their approval on the turnover on downs there for the Cougars. And here we see Tyree Pratt coming out. Here we talk about Tyree's arm, Mark. You got to remember, he's also in the top 10 in rushing in the Mountain State Athletic Conference after 2 weeks as well. A threat with his legs out of the backfield.
Pratt turns. Nazario trying to turn the corner here. Nazario breaking a tackle and takes it up close to the 40-yard line. Let's go down to Joe Stevens.
Mark, you were talking about Tyree Pratt already committing to WVU, but on the Cabell Midland side, number 46, the defensive end that's out there right now, Reese Donahue, is also committed to WVU. So right now, the two opponents could very well be teammates this time next year.
All right, thank you, Joe. And got Dorian Etheridge there, who WVU has told we want you. Here's Pratt. Firing it up, looking for Bays, and just stopped his fingertips.
Bays had the coverage beat that time. It was Alex Ray, the 6-foot junior, trying to match up with him step for step down that far sideline. Bays had it beat and just slightly overthrown. Nice ball, though, by Pratt as that one through the air. Traveled a good 40, 45 yards to get to Bays. A missed opportunity for the Cougars on a long strike there.
Bays had 6 catches in the first game of the season. Under a minute to go here. No score. Nazario gets the call, breaks one tackle, and forges ahead. Slowed down there by number 66, Troy Lucas and company. It's going to be a first down for Capital, and we move the chains. Presented by the West Virginia Oil and Gas Association, celebrating 100 years.
Brad looking over the sideline, John Carpenter instructions. Here with the offense. Down under 10 seconds now left to go in the quarter.
Pratt will keep it. To the 45-yard line he goes. Gain of 2. May have an injured Cabell Midland Knight as the quarter comes to an end. No score, Cabell Midland and Capital on our Friday night football game of the week. Presented by the West Virginia Federal Credit Union. Back in a moment here, WCHSTV.com.
My name is Rose, and I took the Suddenlink Speed Test Challenge. I always knew my old internet was slow, but after comparing it to Suddenlink, that was it for me. We could barely even stream Netflix before. It took forever to download.
Go to speedtest.suddenlink.com and see how much easier life could be.
I should have switched before. You just have to go and take that speed test and see for yourself.
Suddenlink, more power to you.
Get 75 meg high-speed internet for $35 a month when you bundle. Building a garage? Remodeling both bathrooms? Adding another bedroom? When you need cash for home improvements, a college education, or a dream vacation, a West Virginia Federal Credit Union home equity line of credit is the answer. Experience the credit union difference at West Virginia Federal Credit Union. No annual fee, no origination fee, no closing costs, and rates among the best in town. All loans subject to credit and underwriting approval. Contact West Virginia Federal Credit Union for details about credit loans and terms. Let West Virginia Federal Credit Union earn your business.
Back in Wheatley Field. Week three action of high school football in the great state of West Virginia. No score, Cabell Midland and Capital. Tom Hunter, Joe Stevens, Mark Martin. Great to have you along. Boy, what a scene here tonight, Tom.
It's a great night for high school football in the Valley, and this is always, Mark, such a great environment for football because on Friday nights, you got the Friday night lights shining here, and you've got those beautiful lights shining off that gold Capitol Dome. That's over our shot there back at the back toward the Capitol Complex in the far end zone.
Second down and eight for Capitol from the 45. Pratt sets up, going to keep it. Doing what he does best, and will unleash it, and the catch is made and then dropped. Well, McNabb had it, but couldn't hang on. Jarred loose, and it's incomplete. We'll bring up third down and eight.
Looked like Xander Wagner out of the cornerback position in on that hit as well, just knocked that football loose. And again, Pratt, as you said, Mark, doing what he does best on the run, creating things out of this offense, out of broken plays, making things happen when he needs to in this Capitol offense.
Third and eight. Nazario behind Pratt. Stevenson giving pursuit, and here is Nazario, an open field, and Nazario still on his feet and finally slung down, but not before he takes it to the 19-yard line. 46-yard gain, Pratt to Nazario. Troy Lucas ran him down, Tom.
And Lucas that time, that was a touchdown saving tackle for him to ride him down, and he had a hold of him and couldn't take him down for a good 5 yards, finally wrestling him down to the turf. But, you know, those are the kind of opportunities, and you saw that time. Midland sold out and brought a rush of about 3 to 4 to bring the pressure on Pratt, and that's what happens. It opens up the outside. They get to Nazario. He makes things happen.
Trips to the top of your screen. Ball loose, scramble, and I believe Cabell Midland has come up with it. They have.
Chris Camp, the All-Mountain State Athletic Conference defensive selection from a year ago of the middle linebacker position, with a huge turnover and defensive stop for Midland, and the Knights have life here, getting their offense back on the field to try to put some points on the board.
As you mentioned, Camp, that middle linebacker, and 5'10", 200, a senior. Luke Salmon says he may be one of the best linebackers we've ever had at Cabell Midland, at least as far as the time Luke's been there, and that's saying something.
Yeah, it is. Yeah, it is, because Luke Sammons has had some outstanding talent roll through that Midland defense. Well, he's been at the helm of that program down in Ona, done such an outstanding job in putting Midland on the map in Class AAA high school football in the state of West Virginia, following in the shoes of Chip McMillan and that young Knight program.
Now we have a penalty tacked on, it appears.
So it must have been...
Here we go with Doug Spry.
Doug Spry with the signals here. Unsportsmanlike against the Cougars. Must have been a dead ball unsportsmanlike after the whistle blew on the turnover there. And boy, if you're John Carpenter, you don't want to see a mental mistake like that, because that's exactly what that is. You have a kid that loses his cool on the field, and it certainly is costly this time to the Cougars. As Midland Knights set up shop in Capitol territory at the 45.
All right, first and 10 here. Hendricks in motion. Humphrey with the handoff, and we're just trying to follow those blockers in the white jerseys, and taken down by the guys in the blue, and we head down to Joe Stevens.
An explanation on that penalty: it wasn't on any of the players. It was on somebody here on the sidelines that yelled to the referee, somebody not a player and not a coach, but on the sidelines here, and that's why he threw the penalty flag.
No, great crew here working this one tonight. Get a beautiful view from the sideline there in that Capitol Dome in the background. Gain of two. Here is Stapleton zigzagging in the open field. 20-10, touchdown, Cabell Midland. Devin Stapleton races 43 yards, and the Knights strike first.
Stapleton got through a great hole, opened up on that offensive line, and just hit another gear and turned the afterburners on, Mark. Beautiful job of running as he continued to work his way away from defenders, cutting back toward the middle of the field. Big run for Stapleton and a big score for Luke Salmon's Cabell Midland Knights.
It will be Matt Molina, who has had an older brother and an older sister kick for this program. And Matt Molina, the junior, drills it through. It's Cabell Midland 7, Capital nothing here on WCHSTV.com.
No matter what you're looking for, Thornhill Auto Group does it best. Thornhill GM Superstore Corridor G Chapmanville. Thornhill Ford Lincoln Corridor G Chapmanville. Thornhill Factory Outlet of Logan Fountain Place Mall. Thornhill Acura South Charleston. Thornhill Mitsubishi Corridor G Chapmanville. Thornhill Factory Outlet of South Charleston. And Thornhill Commercial Solutions. Thornhill Auto Group. Visit online www.thornhillautomotive.com.
You'll score big when you give West Virginia Federal Credit Union the opportunity to earn your business. West Virginia Federal Credit Union is your community credit union with the goal of building deposit and loan relationships, not just opening accounts. They offer the highest level of service for every member every day and feature a no annual fee debit card that offers cash rewards and surcharge-free ATM access at over 50 locations in the Charleston-Huntington area. It's time to get on the team that has the best game plan. West Virginia Federal Credit Union. Together we all win.
Pooch kick by Cabell Midland, taken in by Quade McNabb, and they will down him at the 37-yard line, back down to the field, and Joe Stevens.
Capital coach John Carpenter is not very happy right now. He asked for an explanation from the referee. He wanted to know what player was in trouble or was called on when it was told to him that it was a fan in the background. He had the police ask the fan to be taken out of the field.
So a fan escorted out of Whaley Field down to that sideline area. Well, it's a tough way to get a penalty.
And it's something they talk about a lot, yeah. You know, just sideline control and who's down there and who should be there. And it would be costly there for the Cougars. And here is Nazario trying to turn the corner and absolutely nowhere to go. And Chris Camp, who came up with that fumble recovery, which of course leads to the touchdown for Cabell Midland, comes up with the stop for the Knights.
And that defensive unit, I mean, up front, Sammy Perry and Brad Smith, and of course Reese Donahue off the end, applying a lot of pressure on Tyree Pratt, but just good containment, smart heads-up defensive play by Cabell Midland has really kept Capital on its toes here early.
Along with Tom Hunter, Joe Stevens, Mark Martin with you. Great to have you along here at UC Stadium in Charleston. Friday night football game of the week presented by the West Virginia Federal Credit Union. Beautiful grab made there by Nazario on the throw from Pratt. Falls it in there at the 44-yard line. Pickup of six. Going to bring up third down for the Cougars.
And Isaiah Duncan, sophomore, on that pass coverage that time for the Knights. Again, one of those younger kids that's getting a lot of snaps, a lot of playing time in this defense. And
yeah, Luke Salmon says Duncan's just very raw. I mean, yeah. So that means you're going to be very good. All right, it's third down and four. Well, when you see Pratt back there, he's been back there for 4 years, you just always sort of have the feeling something good can happen. And John Carpenter hoping that's the case here on third and four from the 43. Pratt sets up, launches, and overshoots Kerry Martin, the outstanding freshman, number four, who had the big game against Riverside, six catches, 88 yards. Had a chance to talk to that young man tonight, and so personable, and boy, he's going to be a good one. But on that particular play, Pratt just couldn't run down the speedy freshman. And it's going to be a punting situation here for the Cougars. It's been a while since Capitals stared at a deficit.
Yeah, it has. And, you know, again, what we expected looking at the recent history in this series, we knew it would be a dogfight, and it has been thus far. And movement on the line as they look to shift things up there on the pre-snap. And the flags there. Officials conferring to determine who jumped first.
Steve Grayley there talking with Doug Spry.
Coming up here in between series, we'll take a look at the Mountain State Athletic Conference scoreboard. And after the Capital punt, bring you up to speed on what else is occurring in the Mountain State Athletic Conference tonight. Taking a look at some other action, other games around the area.
Well, instead of a punt, it's going to be a first down for the Cougars. Boy, that one hurts for Cabell Midland. You got the 7-0 lead and a chance to get the football back. But the penalty will put that Cougar offense back on the field. And we move the chains, presented by the West Virginia Oil and Gas Association, celebrating 100 years. Football at the 49. Trips to the top of your screen. Receiver to the bottom. Pratt. Looks to his right, then goes to Martin. And, boy, they read that one beautifully. And that's Alex Ray, number 6, the junior corner. Started last year for the Knights as a sophomore and makes the big tackle there. No fooling, number 6 on that play. Loss of 4.
Great containment there by the Knights as they've kept the pressure on tonight, both up front and then in that outside containment, closing off the lanes, not giving Capital any opportunities to get upfield.
Nazario lines up beside of Pratt in the backfield. Pratt to midfield and still on his feet. Tyree Pratt to the 42-yard line.
While Luke Sammons has had a lot to be happy about with this defense tonight, he certainly can't be happy there as he had 3 Knights defenders just not wrap. Had opportunities to take Pratt down. They just didn't wrap and tackle with proper technique, missing out on an opportunity to take him down. Fortunately, short of the first down, but it's a 3rd and 1, and Capital needs to keep the momentum rolling here.
13-yard gain for Tyree Pratt. Coming into the contest, Pratt last week, 2 touchdown runs and just drives those legs straight ahead for the first down, and Capitals' drive continues here. We move the chains once more, presented by the West Virginia Oil and Gas Association, celebrating 100 years, and great to be a part of this Friday night football game of the week package presented by the West Virginia Federal Credit Union. So first down and 10 from the 38. Pratt fakes to Nazario. Looking and finds a bit of daylight to the 33-yard line. Give Pratt a gain of 5 on the play before he's knocked out of bounds.
And the only thing stopping Pratt that time was a Capital photographer down on the sidelines as he worked his way out and delicately came to a stop there on the far end of the Capital bench. Nice pickup by Pratt. 2nd down and 5. The Cougars come up to the line. About 7.5 minutes left to go in this opening half of football.
Have a timeout on the field. We'll break away here. It's Cabell Midland 7, Capital nothing.
Have you been fired for filing a workers' comp claim for an injury that happened at work?
Have you been fired because of your race, religion, age, gender, or disabilities?
Did your former employer take longer than 4 business days to get you your final paycheck?
I'm attorney Pat Jacobs. It's against the law to fire employees because of filing a workers' compensation claim. It's also against the law to fire anyone due to discrimination. If any of these things have happened to you, it's just wrong. Don't delay. Call me today.
Henderson Insurance, since 1949, located on Taze Valley Road, Hurricane. We are the trusted choice, proudly supports Hurricane High football. Go Redskins, 304-562-9681.
Ben Franklin Career Center has a variety of programs for those looking for hands-on type work. Enroll in one of the many programs Ben Franklin offers to prepare you for the working world. Ben Franklin Career Center, teaching skills and providing service.
Fresh Seafood Company Restaurant and Market. Yeah, it's that fresh at the Beach House, 6230 McCorkle Avenue.
Second down and five for the Capital Cougars. 7:43 to go here in the first half. They trail by seven. Pressure on to Pratt and trying to hit Nazario, and pass ball is incomplete. Ray was there, and boy, Pratt took a shot as he released that football.
Yeah, and if Alex Ray could have kept his footing, he was kind of leaning, not playing tight to the sideline. He'd been playing a little bit tighter to the sideline. Might have had a shot at getting the INT there around the 15-yard line on that.
Set down to Joe Stevens.
Warming up on the sidelines right now is field goal kicker for the Cougars, Tyler Schaefer. On Friday nights, he kicks field goals. During the week, he plays center midfield for the Capital Cougars soccer team. He has scored 14 goals so far this season.
Yes, indeed, Joe. He is a great athlete. Again, we talked about how John Carpenter says he is money when it comes to kickoffs. Look at some other scores here. Another timeout is called with Midland in the lead here on this third and five.
And as we take a look at the scoreboard from across the Mountain State Athletic Conference tonight, Spring Valley, a little bit of a surprise early, Mark, leading South Charleston 6-0 first quarter score. Huntington leading Parkersburg 10-0, that a first quarter score. Morgantown, Parkersburg South tied up 3-3 at the half, a kicker's battle at Parkersburg South's Erickson All Sports Facility tonight. Also taking a look at AAA scores across the Mountain State. We look at Hurricane leading Riverside 7-0. That's a second quarter score. George Washington leads St. Albans 19-0. That's a first quarter score. And Winfield leads the Ripley Vikings second quarter 22-0.
All right, thank you, Tom, with our MVB score update. It's third and five here from the 33. McNabb in motion. Pratt rolls to his right. Stevenson giving chase, and McNabb makes the running catch and is taken down, but not before it's a first down, knocked out by Hendricks as he makes the grab at the 21-yard line, a 12-yard gain. Tyree Pratt to Quade McNabb.
Pratt that time doing the work with his arm, and Nabb with a great catch and run, and first down as the Cougars keep the chains moving, ball resting at the 21. Time to work with here as we approach halftime.
High formation backfield behind Tyree Pratt, and they fake it to Rush, pitch it to Nazario. Nazario finds an opening, and he goes inside the 15 and down to the 10, taken out of bounds there. Troy Lucas again making the play for Cabell Midland, but not before the Cougars register another first down.
And Lucas that time, as you said, Mark, was there to meet him and take him down, saving another touchdown, saving tackle rather, by Lucas, as he had the one earlier in the drive. And Capital and business looking very good on this series. As now they're set up in the red zone, first down and goal to go for Tyree Pratt's ball club.
They brought Teron Rush in there at fullback position. Pratt keeps it. Tyree Pratt inside the five to the four. Slowed down there by Stevenson. Well, Joe Stevens talked about it. So the WVU commit tackles his future teammate.
And Tanner Smith also in on that stop, as he was able to get the initial hit on him until Donahue able to slow him down and bring him down. Second down and three now at the three.
Reese Donahue. Great player. Hand off Nazario into the end zone. Touchdown, Capital.
And Capital, Mark, getting what they needed to get really out of Silas Nazario last week and were unable to do, and getting him involved early in this offense. He's certainly been a difference maker for John Carpenter's club in this first half of action here at Laidley Field.
So Tyler Schaefer will come in and try to even things. The left footer up and good. We're tied at 7 here at UC Stadium in Charleston, Capital and Cabell Midland.
See the Capital band down there performing the Capital fight song. A lot to celebrate here at Lavely Field as the Cougars back in this ball game. Midland coming out and establishing the tempo early here, punching it into the end zone and getting the first points of the night. But Capital responding, and the defending AAA state champions in a game tonight, as we expected, Mark Martin, with this Midland ball club. And as we look back at the series and how tight these contests have been, nothing out of the unexpected in what we've seen thus far.
Well, and now, and go back. Now, Cabell Midland scores a touchdown off of a turnover. Capital scores a touchdown when they were actually in a position where they had to punt, and you had the penalty. You kept the drive alive, and the Cougars take advantage of that situation and drive it in for a score, and we're even at 7. Schaefer drills it. Stapleton taken out at the 19. It'll be first and 10 for the 19 for the Knights. Harry Oxley, 6'2", 175-pound senior, driving Stapleton out of bounds. And see what kind of formations now will Luke Sammons will choose to go with here. Of course, you know, it doesn't play a lot of guys both ways, but does like to get Reese Donahue in there as much as possible there when he can. And boy, they just bottle up the running back Stapleton.
And Devon Atkins again, he's been there all night, Mark, coming out of that spot up front for the Cougars and been creating havoc in the backfield. Nice stop there by Atkins, the 6'1", 190-pound linebacker.
Had 8 tackles last week in that win over South Charleston, so to loss of 4, Hendricks in motion, and the handoff, and Hendricks got that handoff as he went in motion from Brown. Great call there, and see where they spot him down. It's going to be a first down.
Jordan McCormick that time with a nice hit to bring him down, but not short of the first down as they keep the chains moving. First and 10 at the 31.
About an 18-yard gain there. Handoff, Caperton. Humphrey hammers ahead. Goes from the 31 to the 36-yard line. Gain of 5. 43-yard run by Stapleton. And a 5-yard run by Nazario of Capital. A couple of extra points, and that's where we are. The pitch to Humphrey. Humphrey looking, now cuts back inside. And boy, he just meets a wall of blue jerseys. Teron Rush, number 10, is there, along with several others. Helmet coming off of a
Austin
Capital
Ellis
play. Yeah, Austin Ellis, great offensive lineman and a defensive player as well. And Devin Atkins is there.
He's ever getting his headgear adjusted so he can get back out on the field. Ellis is right now over the Capital bench.
Third down and 2 from the 39. Brown looks over at head coach Luke Sammons. Brown. Well, he wanted to turn and hand it to Hendricks, and Capital read it beautifully.
Guess who? Devon Atkins.
Yeah, Mr. Atkins, followed by Teron Rush, and a big play there by Capital defensively. And the Cougars going to get the football back now here with 3:56 to go on a turning clock. They wind it. Humphrey will drop back to punt. Now let's see what Cabell Midland now. It says fourth and six on the scoreboard.
Yeah. And Luke Sammet's going to take a timeout to talk about it.
We'll take a quick break here at UC Stadium. It's a tie game at 7.
What looks good? Ooh, lobster bisque.
That actually does sound
nice.
Really good.
I want everything on here. Serious.
Okay, this is the third one.
Weird.
Keep tabs on your home, even control it, with the all-new Suddenlink Connected Home, the easy way for peace of mind.
We should probably get home.
Yeah.
How many letters?
5 letters.
Just think about what am I doing right now?
Smile. Smile?
Uh-huh.
This is so easy.
Nobody likes to be stopped by the police, but if I had seen her texting and driving and given her a ticket, it just might have saved her life.
Humphrey from his own 25-yard line, and it hits. And Stapleton will down it at the 45, so that's where Capital will begin offensively here with 3:16 to go. Join us after the game for our Smart 529 Player of the Game. Smart 529 providing families with a unique way to save money for college. And also, following the game, we will hand out our Champions of the Game trophy presented by Hurricane Trophy. Hurricane Trophy located at 3406 Taze Valley Road in Hurricane. Call 304-562-8532.
I just saw that Zool's Frozen Lemonade trailer in the background. It's sounding pretty good right now.
Yes, it does.
It's a little humid tonight, yeah. But a perfect early football night.
That's
in the 2015
job for you
high school.
Time,
I think I should do that.
All right, let's see what the Cougars have in store here now offensively as they try to take the lead. And here is Nazario. Here's a good idea. He will not be caught. Touchdown, Capital. How about that? 55 yards on the first play.
Mark, we've been watching that kid since his freshman year break off those types of runs. They knew he was something special when he broke out and had the big game and a win his freshman year here lately in overtime over Princeton. And he's certainly looking very good tonight for the Cougars.
Nazario, 1,000 all-purpose yards. Last year, and off to a great start in 2015. Schaefer's kick is up and good. 3:11 to go here in the half. 14-7 Capital in the lead on WCHSTV.com.
Drive summary, one play, 50 yards. Nazario on the touchdown run, 9 seconds. And the Cougars, defending AAA state champions, Mark Martin, extending their lead here, 14-7.
5 letters.
Just think about what am I doing right now?
Smile. Smile?
Uh-huh.
This is so easy.
Nobody likes to be stopped by the police. But if I had seen her texting and driving and given her a ticket, it just might have saved her life.
Schaefer will kick it off here for Capital as the Cougars now have the lead. Cabell Midland struck first in this game. Devin Stapleton, a 43-yarder, but since then, two. Silas Nazario, touchdown. Stapleton picks it up at the 5, across the 20, and bangs forward to the 26-yard line. Stapleton is a tough nut.
He is indeed. And, you know, again, you take a look at him and what he's able to do in that backfield. That just gives Luke Salmon's mark, another different type of weapon, different type of tactic that he can take in that offensive playbook. And tonight, Salmon's has been deliberate in keeping a lot of diversity in that playbook. We've seen a little bit of everything that he's thrown at this Capital Cougars defense to keep them on their toes. It'll be interesting to see what he does here in the final 3 minutes of the half.
Ball at the 26-yard line. Handoff straight ahead. Caperton Humphrey. And wrestled down there by Shavers. Nine-yard gain by Caperton Humphrey and brings up second down and one.
They'll take a timeout, I believe, maybe to take a look at the chains, and they go ahead and they're going to move them. Yep, they're going to move the chains. A first down carry, 10-yard pickup for Humphrey. Moves the chains, keeps the drive rolling under 3 minutes to 2:40. First and 10, Cabell Midland.
Luke Salmons signals in the play to Brown. Stapleton in motion, and here goes Brown keeping it, and Brown has another Cabell Midland first down, it appears. Let's see, they bumped him out a yard short of the marker. Been impressed with Brown. He's sat for 2 years behind Coy Pettit, who's now in Marshall's program, and waited his turn. He's worked at it, went to camps, got in the weight room, and now leading this night offense as a senior. Handoff, Humphrey straight ahead, first down as he gets close to midfield. Mac Payton and Teron Rush. Moving those chains, presented by the West Virginia Oil and Gas Association, celebrating 100 years. Midland trying to fight right back here and get it tied before the break. Brown. Stapleton grab around the ankles. Mac Payton making the stop for Javon Brown was there at the end and brings up second and nine. Tight formation for the Knights. Brown in trouble. Brown goes down. Well, getting in there is none other than Devon Atkins, and this young man, just like his brother Khalil, they spent time in boot camp. He was at Fort Leonard Wood in Missouri, lost 11 pounds as he wears number 11. And that advanced individual training, wants to be a welder. And John Carpenter says, when you bring a young man back from something like that, you suddenly have another adult in the locker room.
And the work ethic is unbelievable, and certainly a great leader in that locker room with this Capital Cougars ball club.
Third down and 16, and straight ahead barrels Humphrey. They're just carrying people with him as he takes it to the 45-yard line. Clock is winding down, and looks like Luke Salmons is going to just let it run out.
He may take one shot here. We'll see what he does.
Brown in trouble. And he will be taken down. And who else? Devon Atkins. Good first half of action has come to an end here at UC Stadium. And the Cabell Midland Knights and the defending AAA state champion Capital Cougars, 14-7 battle, the Cougars in the lead over the Knights.
Spot our Joe Stevens down on the sidelines.
I'm going to try to get a word with John Carpenter, who is having a discussion at the moment with Doug Spry. Continuing to have that discussion.
Very animated discussion, I might add.
His team has battled back here from a 7-0 deficit. And They get the lead at 14-7. We will break away here at UC Stadium, and Capital in the lead over the Cabell Midland Knights here on our Friday night football game of the week presented by the West Virginia Federal Credit Union.
No matter what you're looking for, Thornhill Auto Group does it best. Thornhill GM Superstore Corridor G Chapmanville. Thornhill Ford Lincoln Corridor G Chapmanville. Thornhill Factory Outlet of Logan Fountain Place Mall. Thornhill Acura South Charleston. Thornhill Mitsubishi Corridor G Chapmanville. Thornhill Factory Outlet of South Charleston. And Thornhill Commercial Solutions. Thornhill Auto Group. Visit online. www.thornhillautomotive.com.
And we're here with Coach John Carpenter of the Capital Cougars. Coach, the second quarter, you started opening it up. You had the lead at halftime.
Yeah, Silas busted one there and made a good play for us.
It looked like they were containing Pratt there in the beginning, and then he started looking like he was reading his holes a little bit better, opening things up for you.
Yeah, he'd been sick all day, and just took him a little bit to get settled down, but he looks like Tyree Pratt now.
What do you tell the boys at halftime?
It looks like I'm going to have to tell them not to be excited and don't do anything that would show enthusiasm or excitement to play football, because it looks like we're going to get flagged for it. So that's a hard one to have with them. But, you know, I guess don't be excited if you make a play.
Thanks, Coach. Yeah. Coach John Carpenter of the Capital Cougars here at Lely Stadium. It's 14-7. At the halftime, in favor of the Capital Cougars, ranked number one over the number two Cabell Midland Knights, 14-7.
All right, thank you, Joe and John Carpenter. A little upset there. Again, it's been an interesting first half, but a great first half, and we look forward to the second half of action. Two great programs in AAA football in the great state of West Virginia. Our Friday night football game of the week presented by the West Virginia Federal Credit Union. Tom and I will come back, talk about it in just a moment. Our halftime coverage will be coming up as well in just a moment here on WCHSTV.com.
It's Kanawha City on a cloudy afternoon. Donut Connection at the 35th Street Bridge. I stopped to visit Amy and the guys, not thinking about coffee, but it smelled so good, I had a cup. Best in town. Then the choice. Donut, my favorite is Dutch Crumb. Ice cream or a shake. It's a tough choice. They're all made with great love. Start your day at the Donut Connection, Kanawha City. Fresh brewed coffee and donuts baked up, served with love. You'll see. Visit the Donut Connection Facebook for coupons.
A visit to modern medicine starts with a complete and thorough medical checkup of your current condition, after which you'll have a complete diagnosis and a treatment plan that's designed individually for you. If you're looking for a family physician or a medical treatment, come to Modern Medicine.
I was referred by a really good friend of mine. I had the best physical exam I've ever had.
At Modern Medicine, all of our diagnoses and treatments are evidence-based. We do medicine right.
My old phone company internet was slow,
frustrating, unreliable,
exhausting, constant Netflix buffering,
spinning wheel of death.
You can never get back that minute.
We switched to Suddenlink and it was like, phew.
I love it.
Life changing.
Suddenlink lets you connect to everything you love faster and easier. Get the fastest internet in town for less. Suddenlink, more power to you. Get HD TV plus 75 meg broadband internet for just $69 a month.
Building a garage? Remodeling both bathrooms? Adding another bedroom? When you need cash for home improvements, a college education, or a dream vacation, a West Virginia Federal Credit Union home equity line of credit is the answer. Experience the credit union difference at West Virginia Federal Credit Union. No annual fee, no origination fee, no closing costs, and rates among the best in town. All loans subject to credit and underwriting approval. Contact West Virginia Federal Credit Union for details about credit loans and terms. Let West Virginia Federal Credit Union earn your business.
Change. Sometimes it hurts. Sometimes it can break your will, but it shouldn't beat you. You're an everyday athlete, and you've built this machine to overcome adversity. Welcome to the Marshall Sports Medicine Institute, where we've brought together the most comprehensive team of physicians, physical therapists, and athletic trainers in the region to keep you in the game. Change is good. The Marshall Sports Medicine Institute, the region's game changer.
Back inside UC Stadium here in Charleston, halftime in our Friday night football game of the week presented by the West Virginia Federal Credit Union, and it is the Capital Cougars leading the Cabell Midland Knights by a count of 14-7. Along with Tom Hunter, Joe Stevens, I'm Mark Martin. Great to have you with us. Impressions of the first half.
Well, Silas Azario, you know, we talked about it early and often. He was a guy you didn't see get really involved in the offense last week until late in the win over South Charleston. They need to get him involved early tonight, and they certainly do that. 8 carries for 94 yards along of course, the 55-yard touchdown run that really broke things open for Capital to give them a 14-7 lead rolling into halftime. He's been a difference maker for the Capital Cougars. And if you look at the other side of the ball for Midland, Luke Sammons has to be overall very pleased with how his defensive unit has played. They, for the most part, kept Tyree Pratt in check, haven't allowed him to get the long ball loose to Chunky Bays, and certainly have kept the passing game in check. But there are some things that they need to do and need to address in terms of tackling. A couple opportunities there to wrap up Nazario and Pratt on big runs, and they just couldn't do it and let them get loose, and that's what kept those Capital drives sustained in this first half.
Here, Cabell Midland took the lead on a 43-yard scamper by Devin Stapleton, a 7-0 lead, all the scoring coming in the second quarter, and then a short touchdown run by Nazario, and then his big 55-yard gallop, and that's where we are here at the break. And again, it's been a slugfest, and well, 35-28 a year ago, I think we may be on the line
well
or something like
way.
That.
We're well on our way, and those lemonades are sounding even better.
All right, buddy. Okay, we're looking forward to it. And Joe Stevens will have our halftime coverage from down on the field in just a moment. You're watching our Friday Night Football Game of the Week presented by the West Virginia Federal Credit Union. At the break, it is Capital 14 and Cabell Midland 7. We're back with more in a moment here on WCHSTV.com.
Arby's sandwiches have always been crafted for two medium to large-sized hands. Until now. Arby's new $1.29 sliders are still meat-crafted with your favorite meats, but meant to be eaten one-handed, freeing up your other hand for a second Arby's slider. Arby's new $1.29 sliders. Arby's, we have the meats.
And welcome back to Lely Field here for the WCHSTV.com Game of the Week. It's Capital 14, Cabell Midland 7. Joining us now here at halftime is Tom Bragg, who is with the Gazette Mail Sports Department. You read the WVHuddle.com all the time if you stay up with the high school sports. Tom is pretty much in charge of that, making sure that thing is rolling smoothly. Tom, the first half tonight, it was kind of what everybody was expecting, I think.
Yeah, absolutely. Both of these teams very talented, very physical. They sort of felt each other out, it seemed, the first few drives. Cabell Midland able to get the touchdown after the Capital turnover. But then, you know, if you're Luke Sammons, what you didn't want to see right before halftime, they punt the ball. Capital has that long touchdown run by Silas Nazario, first play, and end up down a touchdown with Capital getting the ball after the half.
You can stay with them head-to-head, Cabell Midland against Capital, South Charleston against Capital. But as soon as they can get outside and that speed takes over, it's a different story.
Oh, absolutely. And you saw that in the first half several times. Capital's quarterback Tyree Pratt looked like they had him dead to rights in the backfield. He's able to slip a guy, get a block, get to the sideline, and get a long first down. And that really was what Capital was able to do to keep some drives going and maybe keep Midland off of them a little bit.
Second half, what do you think? Cabell Midland's got that two-platoon situation. Not a lot of people going both ways. Stapleton just one of them that I've been watching so far. Will that wear Capital down? Or I've been seeing a lot of subs that John Carpenter's been sending in too.
Well, if one thing about Capital is they do have depth. They can keep up with that two platoon system, and you know they're undefeated through last season, number one in the state so far this year. It seems like Capital's going to be the champ until someone knocks them off. This is a very good Cabell Midland team though. It should be a good second half.
15 wins in a row for Capital right now, Tommy. You know, a neat thing, we talked about it during the game, Reese Donahue playing defensive end, going to WVU, playing for Cabell Midland, Tyree Pratt, a commitment to WVU. They're going head-to-head right now. They've locked horns a couple times in the game here. This time next year, they're standing on the same sidelines.
And, you know, that's great to see. And in years past, you haven't been able to see a game where there might be two in-state kids that are
Ladies
playing at such a high level that have committed to go to WVU. So looking forward to more in the second half.
So right now, Until somebody knocks them off, they're staying at number one.
I think that's going to be the case. I mean, this is a really good team. A win against Cabell Midland, no matter who you are, it's a good win. And number one's number one.
Okay, I'll let you go after this one. Tell me what's going to happen in the second half. Look into your crystal ball there.
Oh, gosh. I think Cabell Midland might be able to get another score, but Capital's tough to keep up with. I think probably Capital's going to take this one, we'll say, maybe by 14 points, two touchdowns.
Tom Bragg with the Gazette Mail. And is it Charleston Gazette Mail and WV Huddle.com. There you go. It's 14-7 halftime here at Laidley Field in favor of the Capital Cougars for the WCHS-TV.com Game of the Week. There's a lot of things going on here at Laidley Field. Some new lights. We might be seeing a new carpet. And we might be seeing a new scoreboard. We're going to find out more about that from Doug Cart, who's in charge of this stadium, right after this.
At DHG, we are passionate about helping our clients succeed, and we do so through a resourceful approach in helping our clients achieve their goals. Our passion to serve goes beyond the work we do for our clients. Whether we're giving our time or providing financial support, DHG is committed to building better communities. When you work with us, you get a relationship with a great team fully dedicated to your success.
Trinity Rebar and Concrete Supplies, a West Virginia-owned company with in-state workers that provides money locally. At Trinity, we provide today's materials for tomorrow's projects. Our projects include the engineering complex at Marshall University, dormitories at Glenville State College, Cabela's, and other commercial projects. We do business the old-fashioned way with honesty, integrity, and dependability. Let Trinity be your partner on your next commercial project. Trinity Rebar, 304-755-5100. Online at trinityrebar.com.
You'll score big when you give West Virginia Federal Credit Union the opportunity to earn your business. West Virginia Federal Credit Union is your community credit union with the goal of building deposit and loan relationships, not just opening accounts. They offer the highest level of service for every member every day and feature a no annual fee debit card that offers cash rewards and surcharge-free ATM access at over 50 locations in the Charleston-Huntington area. It's time to get on the team that has the best game plan. West Virginia Federal Credit Union. Together we all win.
Back here at Laidley Stadium, it's 14-7 in favor of Capital over Cabell Midland. Number one, one touchdown over number two right now here at Laidley Stadium. Well, there's been a little difference between day and night right now because one set of the stadium has brand new lights, the other side coming this week. Joining us now is Doug Cart, the director here at Laidley Field. Doug, we've seen the lights. You can see the difference already. What's going on right now for the renovations?
Well, you well know, Joe, this week we started on the north side. They're up and ready to go. Starting next week, we go with the south side. They'll be up. We'll premiere the whole lighting during the Kanawha County School Majorette Festival next the 22nd of Tuesday. After that, we get this all going. I'm on the working on putting up a new scoreboard. I'm looking for sponsors to help me a little bit. After that, we're in negotiations with a track company that is working with us. We would like to expand the football field and take out the crown, put in lacrosse, soccer, and put in a new track, and then we're ready. We'll be the best stadium in West Virginia.
Now, you're looking at these renovations, you're talking about the scoreboard. What kind of timetable, what type of time frame are we talking about for the scoreboard, the new carpet here on the field, and if not, a new track?
Well, if somebody would call me up on Monday morning and help me with the scoreboard, we could have it up in probably a month at the latest. We're probably looking with the track and the turf about a year, year and a half. We're looking at blueprints right now to see if it can feasibly be done for the renovations that we want to do.
Now, I know Mark has talked about this on TV and the renovations and everything. Just how big of a community effort is this? This is not just Doug Cart picking up the phone and saying, I need your help. There's a lot of folks in the community that are working with you.
Yeah, there's a lot. I really like to thank Kanawha County Schools. They're the ones who put the money in the budget for the new lighting. It's great. I am so excited about that. When it comes to the scoreboard and We are looking for sponsors to help us with that. I'm about two short. That tells you how close we are. The turf is under a contract with UC, so that's with us and UC.
It's going to be a great stadium when it's all done. I know it's something you're going to be proud of.
Yes, sir. I'm really excited, and the city of Charleston has to be. Thank you, Joe.
Doug Cart, director here at Laidley's Field, and talking about the renovations. It's halftime for the WCHSTV.com Game of the Week. Number one, Capital, 14, Cabell Midland, 7. We're going to have some high school band action when we come back from these commercials.
My old phone company internet was
slow,
frustrating, unreliable,
exhausting, constant Netflix buffering,
spinning wheel of death.
You can never get back that minute.
We switched to Suddenlink and it was like,
I love it.
Life changing.
Suddenlink lets you connect to everything you love faster and easier. Get the fastest internet in town for less. Suddenlink, more power to you. Get HD TV plus 75 meg broadband internet for just $69 a month.
Carver Career and Technical Center specializes in helping you reach your career goals, offering certificate and short-term education programs designed to prepare both secondary students and adult learners for employment. Don't put off your future another day. Contact Carver Career and Technical Center today.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for the pride of Capital High School Marching Band.
Carver Career and Technical Center specializes in helping you reach your career goals, offering certificate and short-term education programs designed to prepare both secondary students and adult learners for employment. Don't put off your future another day. Contact Carver Career and Technical Center today.
Henderson Insurance, since 1949, located on Taze Valley Road, Hurricane. We are the trusted choice. Proudly supports Hurricane High football. Go Redskins, 304-562-9681.
Have you been fired for filing a workers' comp claim for an injury that happened at work?
Have you been fired because of your race, religion, age, gender, or disabilities?
Did your former employer take longer than 4 business days to get you your final paycheck?
I'm attorney Pat Jacobs. It's against the law to fire employees because of filing a workers' compensation claim. It's also against the law to fire anyone due to discrimination. If any of these things have happened to you, it's just wrong. Don't delay. Call me today.
Fresh Seafood Company Restaurant and Market serves Charleston's freshest seafood favorites and is home to the Big Fish Sandwich. Join us today for lunch or dinner at the Beach House. It doesn't get any fresher than Fresh Seafood Company Restaurant and Market.
Green Valley 14, South Charleston 7.
And we welcome you back live inside UC Stadium, our Friday night football game of the week presented by the West Virginia Federal Credit Union, along with Tom Hunter, Joe Stevens. Our great crew and Mark Martin, thanks for being with us here. Good one as Capital leads Cabell Midland 14-7, 7 points the difference a year ago.
The Capital High School football team
in this first half, Cabell Midland with 10 first downs, Capital with 8 rushing yards, about even. Cabell Midland 117, Capital 118, though Capital Midland has rushed the football 15 more times. Passing yards, Capital leads the way with 15, Tyree Pratt 5 of 11 in the first half. Total offense, Capital 169 to Cabell Midland's 133. Penalty-wise, Cabell Midland 2 for 11, Capital 3 for 35. Time of possession right now, Cabell Midland with a sizable difference there, 15:07 to 8:53. Capital has converted 4 out of 6 third downs. Cabell Midland 1 out of 6, and on fourth down, Cabell Midland 1-3. Silas Nazario with 88 first half yards. Had the big 55-yard touchdown run. Tyree Pratt again, 5 of 11 passing. Nazario with 2 catches for 41 yards. Quade McNabb with 1 for 12. Miguel Crunchy Bays just 1 catch for 2 yards. For Cabell Midland, Caperton Humphrey's been the workhorse, 14 carries, 55 yards. Devin Stapleton 9 for 54. And Tyler Brown 1-2 passing for 16 yards, and that catch was made by Caperton Humphrey. Get a good look there at Luke Sammons, the head coach of Cabell Midland. When he was at Lawrence County, Kentucky, his first season as the head coach, 0-11, and they went 13-1 the next season. Greatest turnaround in the history of Kentucky high school football. Had one more season there at 10-2. Has a career record of 68-31. Of course, had Cabell Midland in the state championship, 13-1, a couple of seasons back. John Carpenter, the head coach of Capital, 47-14. 3 straight playoff appearances, and of course, guided the Cougars to the school's first state championship since 1995. So Capital, Tom Hunter will get the football to start this second half in this 7-0 lead, or 7-point lead.
You talk about the program that Luke Sammons has built. You look at the schedule, Mark, this season for the Knights, and year in, year out, it's a tough schedule. But this season, you know, tonight at Capital, they're on the road for the first 3 weeks of the year. Then they've got to face South Charleston on the road, Belfry, Kentucky, which won a state championship in the state of Kentucky last year. Then at Huntington, finish out with Parkersburg, GW, and Hurricane. A tough schedule.
And the pooch kick, and boy, McNabb makes a great diving catch for it at the 35-yard line. Well, I'm not a big fan of that kick, but you see why coaches do it right there. That was dangerous.
Yeah, it was, but the hands team came up huge, and certainly is going to put the Cougars in a good spot to start off the second half of action as their offense goes back on the field, first and 10 at the 35. And be interested to see what adjustments offensively John Carpenter makes, if he tries to go for the kill here early and really open things up in the playbook, or if they play a more conservative ball control offense to try to grind it out.
Football to 35. In motion comes Bays. Pratt will keep, and Pratt will be slung down hard there. Good read there by Cabell Midland defensively, and it will be no gain on the play. In on the stop, Noah Cooper, Jr., 5'10", 175, and an injured player there for Cabell Midland, and that is
Isaiah Duncan.
Yeah, Isaiah Duncan. Young man, the outside linebacker, they call it the Knight, and again, he's a young man we talked about that Luke Salmon says a very raw, talented kid. Got a great future, but right now he is down. And Luke Salmon's coming out to check on the youngster. We'll take a break here on WCHSTV.com. 14-7, Capital in the lead over Cabell Midland.
Building a garage? Remodeling both bathrooms? Adding another bedroom? When you need cash for home improvements, a college education, or a dream vacation, a West Virginia Federal Credit Union home equity line of credit is the answer. Experience the credit union difference at West Virginia Federal Credit Union. No annual fee, no origination fee, no closing costs, and rates among the best in town. All loans subject to credit and underwriting approval. Contact West Virginia Federal Credit Union for details about credit loans and terms. Let West Virginia Federal Credit Union earn your business.
No matter what you're looking for, Thornhill Auto Group does it best. Thornhill GM Superstore Corridor G, Chapmanville. Thornhill Ford Lincoln Corridor G, Chapmanville. Thornhill Factory Outlet of Logan, Fountain Place Mall. Thornhill Acura, South Charleston. Thornhill Mitsubishi Corridor G, Chapmanville. Thornhill Factory Outlet of South Charleston. And Thornhill Commercial Solutions. Thornhill Auto Group. Visit online. www.thornhillautomotive.com.
Duncan, the injured player, up and running off on his own power. Second and 10. Pratt in trouble. Stevenson. And he throws it away. I tell you what, Tyree Pratt does a great job avoiding the rush.
He has the ability with those quick feet. And with 4 years under his belt, Mark, a lot of experience, a lot of trust there that John Carpenter shows in his leader to make decisions and make things happen on the field.
A lot of his development, too, could be attributed to Jared Ferguson, their quarterback coach. Ferguson was an outstanding player at Fairmont State, Fairmont senior grad, and then played for the Falcons. And Bob Cable, their longtime trainer, says Jared Ferguson may be the best quarterback in Fairmont history in his opinion, and Pratt goes down. Boy, Stapleton, seeing him on defense as well here in this game, and that was a hard hit, and he takes Pratt to the ground.
Stapleton just flying to the football out of that free safety position again, as we mentioned earlier in the broadcast, an all MSAC selection on the defensive side of the football, first teamer last year for Luke Salmon's ball club, and certainly showing that he has the potential to be an all-conference and potential all-state performer at the position this year.
So we have a new punter into the game for Capital. Timeout on the field. We'll break away here. Capital leads Cabell Midland 14-7 on our Friday night football game of the week presented by the West Virginia Federal Credit Union.
A visit to modern medicine starts with a complete and thorough medical checkup of your current condition, after which you'll have a complete diagnosis and a treatment plan that's designed individually for you. If you're looking for a family physician or a medical treatment, come to Modern Medicine.
I was referred by a really good friend of mine. I had the best physical exam I've ever had.
At Modern Medicine, all of our diagnoses and treatments are evidence-based. We do medicine right.
Connor Reeves is the punter for Capital. Now it looks like they've changed back and it will be Atkins. Reeves was in there, and Atkins, tough one that floats up there, and the catch is made at the 35-yard line by Caperton Humphrey.
So Midland, it's kind of a back and forth here on the field position. Capital started the drive at the 35, it stalled. Now Midland takes over at the 35 for their first chance in offense here in the second half, looking to regain some of the momentum that they established early. Got on the scoreboard first here on the staple, the touchdown run, and then Capital strikes twice to lead this thing 14-7. Let's see what Luke Sammons opens up here with the offensive playbook.
With that line of Jordan King, Briar Ellswick, Lucas Jacobs, Hunter Hicks, Tanner Sweeney, Tanner Mullins and Reese Donahue, the tight ends, and the handoff straight ahead. Humphrey, I'm going to tell you what, at this moment, you would think that Luke Sammons just likes what they can do grinding with this young man.
Yeah, and with the rotation of backs, but particularly with Humphrey, you know, again, Stapleton, Hendricks, and then Brown can use his feet to work out of situations. Like we mentioned at halftime, he showed a lot of things in the playbook in that first half and a lot of diversity in this offense.
Here is Brown. He will keep it and take it down. Nice job there again by Devon Atkins. Boy, what a game he has had so far. And this one far from over. Third down and call it three from the 38-yard line.
We may be talking about this young man as a smart 529 player of the game. He's just, it's been that kind of performance thus far from Devon Atkins and this Capital defense.
From the 42, the handoff, keeping it is Brown and Dorian Etheridge and others having none of it. Forcing the Knights to punt it away. Etheridge, just a junior, D1 recruit.
Lots been said, Mark, in the preseason, the early part of the season here about the growing crop of D1 recruits in the state. And two fine examples here with these programs.
Fourth and three. Capital. And they stop Cabell Midland as they go for it on fourth down, and Devin Stapleton, and they do. Luke Sammons, the Riverboat Gambler. But on that particular situation, Dorian Etheridge and the Cougars, along with Teron Rush, they stop Cabell Midland short of the first down, and Capital will have excellent field position.
Well, and with that play call, Luke Sammons showing a little bit of confidence in his defense and also issuing a little bit of a challenge to his defense here early. You've got to step it up and protect turf if we're going to have to take advantage of an opportunity to keep a drive rolling like that in our own territory. So a lot expected in this series of this Cabell Midland defense to hold the line.
Football at the 44-yard line. Two backs line up behind a Pratt, and he will give it to Nazario, who slips through and gets inside the 40 to the 39-yard line. Stop made there by the defensive end, Reese Donahue. 6'5", 230, a senior. Gain of five for Nazario Pratt. Pitches to Crunchy Bays, and Bays taken down in open field. Nice play there on the outside by Cabell Midland.
Adam Bays. Stratton.
Yeah, Adam Stratton there.
He shut Crunchy down. Crunchy looked to get that burst of speed to get to the outside, and Stratton came in flying to the football and dove in. Nice tackle that time by Stratton.
Now Stratton's a young man. He's been dealing with injuries for 2 years. He's now a senior. Luke Salmon says he's raring to go. Handoff to Nazario. Camp takes him down. We're going to bring up fourth down for Capital. Cougars in the lead. A couple of touchdowns by Nazario, Devin Stapleton, got Cabell Midland on the board first. And looks like the Cougars are going to call a timeout, and from the reaction down there by John Carpenter, didn't want to, but no, I don't guess he did. Now he did, okay. I don't think he wanted to. We'll take a break here. Cougars by seven, facing a fourth down here on our Friday Night Football Game of the Week presented by the West Virginia Federal Credit Union.
You'll score big when you give West Virginia Federal Credit Union the opportunity to earn your business. West Virginia Federal Credit Union is your community credit union with the goal of building deposit and loan relationships, not just opening accounts. They offer the highest level of service for every member every day and feature a no annual fee debit card that offers cash rewards and surcharge-free ATM access at over 50 locations in the Charleston-Huntington area. It's time to get on the team that has the best game plan. West Virginia Federal Credit Union. Together we all win.
Ben Franklin Career Center has a variety of programs for those looking for hands-on type work. Enroll in one of the many programs Ben Franklin offers to prepare you for the working world. Ben Franklin Career Center, teaching skills and providing service.
Tom Hunter, your thoughts here as Capital calls the timeout.
Well, you know, we said at the beginning of the series, Luke taking that chance on offense in his own territory. You got to show a lot of confidence in your defense, and it's gut check time. Fourth down and short, you got to stop them here and get the football back.
They line Atkins up as a wing on the near side. Pratt working with a long count. And now the play clock hits zero. And they may be setting it up here just to try to pin Cabell Midland deep with the punt. So Pratt and his offensive crew will walk over, and punt team is heading out.
Vaughn Atkins going back again, and we've talked about it a lot throughout this telecast night. What a night that young man has had. Some big defensive stops in on a lot of tackles. And
he's had some nice punts, too. Yeah, he has. 35-yarder there in the quick kick here, and this one is going to roll, and can the Cougars speed run it down? They cannot. So, Luke Sammons goes for it on fourth down. Capital had great field position, but then we see the Knight defense respond, and so Capital will now go back to the prevent side, leading by seven.
Again, you look at on the night for this cap or for the Cabell Midland Knights offense. And Tyler Brown's only gone to the air twice all night. One time had a wide open shot down the middle of the field there in the first half and just overthrew the receiver. It could have been six, and be interesting to see when Luke Sammons takes those rare occasions to put the ball back in the air here to try to get Midland back in this ball game.
Brown behind center. The lefty wants to throw, fires it out, and the catch made by Stapleton across the 40 and banged out of bounds at the 45-yard line.
And just like we were talking about, he's got it in the playbook. He's gone to it sparingly, but that time it comes up huge as Brown drops back. Great pocket protection, had plenty of time to throw, and Stapleton, a speedster when he gets in that outside lane, finds space, gets the open lane, and a good pickup for the Cabell Midland Knights.
Moving the Chains, presented by the West Virginia Oil and Gas Association, celebrating 100 years. It was a 26-yard pickup on the pass and catch, and then Humphrey gets the call. May have gotten one. After the game, we will present our Smart 529 Player of the Game. Smart 529 providing families with a unique way to save money for college. And also join us following the game as we hand out our Champions of the Game trophy presented by Hurricane Trophy on the Taze Valley Road. Humphrey has the first down and more as he hammers his way down to the 31-yard line of Capital.
Just a bulldozer, Mark.
17-yard gain for Humphrey.
A bulldozer who has speed when he can get to the outside, can make things happen, can pound it up the middle and beat ahead for that hard yardage. Just great running back.
Has a lot of schools looking at him. Now they go back to the speed, and Stapleton spins out of traffic and gets inside the 25 to the 24. Boy, looked like they had him all bottled up, but that's what those great backs with the great eyes do. He saw something and he spins away from all the cluster and gets nine on the play. Now they go misdirection and it will be Hendricks getting the call, and he has the first down. And we have a penalty flag coming out. And this may, if you go by the reaction of the Capital players against Cabell Midland, but I've learned over time never judge it on the reaction of players. Although, Doug Spry, it is going to go against the Knights. And boy, that one hurts.
That one does hurt. And, you know, and for everything that Luke Sammons does and how well he manages the play clock. Luke can pick up this offense, and they can take the tempo and go quick. He is so good about managing the play clock, and when he needs to work it down, he works it down, but when he needs to pick it up, he picks it up. But if you do such a good job in those facets of the game, that's the areas of the game right there where you shoot yourself in the foot, and that's something certainly that Luke Sammons Ball Club couldn't afford to do right now, was to have a penalty to take them out of what was building momentum to get a good scoring drive here set up.
Takes the Knights back to the 38. Brown fakes the handoff, launches, throws it down, and intended for Stapleton, falls incomplete. Brings up second down.
Went down the middle of the field. All the coverage was socked down in the middle of the field, and that time the two-thirds of the field to the right side of the line was clear and wide open. If you run an end out there in that flat, it's wide open, but instead they decide to go all the way downfield. Fortunate they did not throw the interception that time.
Saw number 9 there on the coverage, Anthony Pittman. He is a sophomore, just one of the other talented youngsters on this team. Humphrey carries it for no gain. Dorian Etheridge there with the stop. Humphrey going to play ball at the next level. Etheridge is going to play ball at the next level. There's a lot on both sides of the ball here tonight. We'll see. On Saturdays, as they like to say. Both of these programs have several young men playing college football at the moment. Third down and 7. Hendricks in motion. Misdirection. Stapleton. Well, he takes a shot from Etheridge. And he goes down at the 34. He picked up 2 on the play. That will bring up 4th down for Cabell Midland. Yeah. I mean, Etheridge
leveled him.
Some heavy lumber there on Stapleton. He put those pads right on him. 4th and 5.
And play clock down inside 10 seconds, rolling to 5 now.
Brown in trouble. Brown goes down. Teron Rush, number 10 from the defensive end side, a sack a week ago, and he takes down Brown, and Cabell Midland turns the football over, and the offense goes back to work for Capital, leading at 14-7. With just a little over 5 to play here in the third.
Situation a bit reminiscent of what occurred last year early in that fourth quarter. Midland had all the momentum, had a 4th and 1 inside the Capital 20, and a penalty, marched them back, killed the drive. Similar situation. They're marching, momentum rolling their way to get something going. Penalty pretty much killed that drive, Mark.
Now, I believe we're going to have movement against Capital. Ball start, and that will take them back 5. Capital a year ago on the road to Wheeling and the state championship. They played all 3 games here to get to Wheeling. Beat Parkersburg South 70-0, Wheeling Park 35-14, and then ended Martinsburg's great run 55-15. And at the moment, a 16-game regular season winning streak. Pratt lifting it up and off the hands of Kerry Martin. Point Pleasant playing Wayne tonight, and it's always been a great battle. Point Pleasant, boy, what a program Dave Darce has going there. They've been AA and AAA. Right now they have the longest regular season winning streak at 25.
It looks like they'll keep that going tonight based on what we're seeing up in Point Pleasant. We'll give you a score update here on an in-between series from our MVB scoreboard and score update.
2nd and 5. Pratt faking it to Nazario, now floats it out, intended for Atkins. Pretty nice call there by John Carpenter.
And that time Pratt put the ball where he needed to put it. I mean, you can't ask for a much better ball thrown than that, and just got it just about a step in front of Atkins, couldn't get to it. Flag down on the field. They're talking to the Midland captain, so it looks like it's going to go against the Cougars. Ineligible downfield, declined, and take it to third down. So third and 15 situation, Mark, and just under a five-minute mark left to go in this third quarter. It's been a dandy between two heavyweights in Class AAA, the number one Capital Cougars and Cabell Midland.
Pratt, hands to Nazario, drives those legs to the 48-yard line. Stop made by Javon Light, strong safety, and an injured Capital player, and that's Savion Brown.
And you don't want to see that. You hope it's just a cramping issue and something you work off here, but he's frustrated. He's in pain.
John Carpenter says he's as good as we've had. So we have a break in the action here. Capital 14, Cabell Midland 7 on our Friday Night Football Game of the Week presented by the West Virginia Federal Credit Union. Back in a moment.
Change. Sometimes it hurts. Sometimes it can break your will, but it shouldn't beat you. You're an everyday athlete, and you've built this machine to overcome adversity. Welcome to the Marshall Sports Medicine Institute, where we've brought together the most comprehensive team of physicians, physical therapists, and athletic trainers in the region to keep you in the game. Change is good. The Marshall Sports Medicine Institute, the region's game changer.
My name is Rose, and I took the Suddenlink Speed Test Challenge. I always knew my old internet was slow, but after comparing it to Suddenlink, that was it for me. We could barely even stream Netflix before. It took forever to download.
Go to speedtest.suddenlink.com and see how much easier life could be.
I should have switched before. You just have to go and take that speed test and see for yourself.
Suddenlink, more power to you.
Get 75 meg high-speed internet for $35 a month when you bundle.
No matter what you're looking for, Thornhill Auto Group does it best. Thornhill GM Superstore Corridor G, Chapmanville. Thornhill Ford Lincoln Corridor G, Chapmanville. Thornhill Factory Outlet of Logan, Fountain Place Mall. Thornhill Acura, South Charleston. Thornhill Mitsubishi Corridor G, Chapmanville. Thornhill Factory Outlet of South Charleston. And Thornhill Commercial Solutions. Thornhill Auto Group. Visit online, www.thornhillautomotive.com.
Well, Savion Brown coming off the field, appears to be an ankle injury, and just an outstanding player for Capital. Four-year regular, and hopefully it's nothing too serious. May not see him the rest of the way here, but the way he came off there, and the punt, Reeves is the punter for Capital. Ball goes out of bounds, so nice punt there by Reeves, and spotted at the 13-yard line, so Cabell Midland will go back offensively here.
Mark, you mentioned our scores around the state. Of course, you can catch up with all the action tonight after our telecast on the mothership, WCHS-TV8. Friday Night Football Extra, Mark and Kenny and Josh and the crew will be in studio giving you all the updates, and we take a look at our MVB score update here tonight. Mentioned Point Pleasant, longest regular season winning streak. They're ahead 30-8 right now on Wayne. Huntington leading Parkersburg 10-0. Morgantown leading Parkersburg South 17-10. We'll go to the play and look at some more scores in a moment.
All right, Humphrey gets the call and barrels his way to the 18.
Taking a look at some other scores. Mountain State Athletic Conference, Hurricane leads Riverside third quarter 14-6. George Washington, 40-0 lead over St. Albans at halftime. Ripley trails Winfield at halftime, 36-0. Of course, all the scores and highlights, again, on TVA, 11:15 tonight, Friday Night Football Extra with Mark Martin, Kenny, and Josh and the crew.
Second down, five. Handoff, Hendricks. Hendricks has an opening. Hendricks has the first down as he shoots ahead to the 32-yard line. The ball did come loose, but I believe Hendricks was down. Nope. What are they saying here? Another player down. All right.
That time it's Jordan McCormick. So Jordan McCormick comes up after he looked like he rolled up an ankle just a little bit.
And McCormick, hard-nosed kid, according to John Carpenter, just real important to him to be a high school football player at Capital, but he runs off own will. First and 10 now, football at the 32. ...14-yard gain by Jacob Hendricks. Grinding those legs. Stapleton out over the 35 to the 36. Austin Ellis makes the stop as the clock continues to turn here in the third.
Mac Payton also in, and you know, Payton was a name that we called out a lot last week. We've called it out a few times tonight as he's been in on a lot of those plays, assisting on tackles for that Cougars defense.
Hendricks in motion, Humphrey gets the call, and Humphrey goes barging ahead to the 39-yard line. Mac Payton is there. This Cabell Midland team we will see again next week on our Friday Night Football Game of the Week, presented by the West Virginia Federal Credit Union. First home game of the season for the Knights at Knight Stadium there in Ona, the Castle. And they'll take on John H. Lilly's Beckley Woodrow Wilson Flying Eagles. They lost a heartbreaker last week. It was their opener in week two of the season to rival Greenbrier East. And at the moment, Bluefield having its way with the Flying Eagles. And Stapleton carves his way to the 41-yard line. Gain of two, and that's going to bring up another fourth down.
Similar situation to what Luke Sammons faced when he took the gamble and went for the fourth down in that earlier series. And down a score and down to the last 2 minutes of the third quarter, you got to make something happen. You show confidence in your defense, and what Luke Sammons is going to do again, he goes for it on fourth down.
Got Reese Donahue there for some extra blocking. Flag is down. Humphrey has the first down, but we'll see what the flag is all about.
Probably going to be a hold. Flag came in off the far sideline, off the Capitol sideline, rather, and it is a false start. So it brings back that first down run.
They brought in that extra blocking. Reese Donahue, the 6'5", 230-pound senior, heading off to WVU. And
talk about Donahue, he's also an All-American, Mark, selected to play in the 2016 Blue-Gray All-American Bowl in Tampa on January 9th, so some great accolades for this Division I recruit, Reese Donahue.
All right, Nazario back deep. Humphrey will punt it. Puts that left leg into this one, and Nazario is going to scoop it up at the 16 and then be corralled at the 20-yard line. So nice job by the coverage team there on the punt by Cabell Midland. Jacob Morrison, number 43, a 6'2", 225-pound junior, makes the stop. So good punt by Humphrey, and Capital will take over, leading it 14-7 here. Just a little over a minute to go in the third. Let's head down to the field. And our Joe Stevens. Joe?
Well, we got an injury report on Savion Brown. He twisted his ankle the way he fell back. And right now they're planning to try to get him back in the game. They're going to tape it up, get cleats back on him. He wants to go back in the game.
Of course he does. Great player that he is. And here is another great player in Nazario dashing his way to the 31-yard line. An 11-yard gain. So using the blocking on the right side of that line. Of course, the center is Chris Harris, a three-year starter. Austin Ellis, a four-year starter, along with Brown. They call Ellis, the right guard, a barroom brawler. And Trace Chaffins, he was a fullback in August, now playing that right tackle position. First and 10 at the 31. Nazario again, and he's going to be stood up this time. Nice defense there by the Knights of Cabell Midland.
Brandon Nash was in there, the sophomore out of tackle position, got a jersey, armful, a handful of jersey rather, from Nazario, was able to hold him up at the line.
See Brown there. Four-year starter, All-Stater a season ago, All-Mountain State Athletic Conference, of course. Gain of one, second and nine, and clock winding down, and we are going to move to action in the fourth quarter. It's Capital 14, Cabell Midland 7 on our Friday night football game of the week presented by the West Virginia Federal Credit Union.
Building a garage? Remodeling both bathrooms? Adding another bedroom? When you need cash for home improvements, a college education, or a dream vacation, a West Virginia Federal Credit Union home equity line of credit is the answer. Experience the credit union difference at West Virginia Federal Credit Union. No annual fee, no origination fee, no closing costs, and rates among the best in town. All loans subject to credit and underwriting approval. Contact West Virginia Federal Credit Union for details about credit loans and terms. Let West Virginia Federal Credit Union earn your business.
How many letters?
5 letters.
Just think about, what am I doing right now?
Smile. Smile?
Uh-huh.
This is so easy.
Nobody likes to be stopped by the police. But if I had seen her texting while driving and given her a ticket, it just might have saved her life.
Another great band of Cabell Midland here tonight in the capital city. Outstanding performances by both bands at halftime. We start the fourth quarter, and Nazario bangs his way across the 35 to the 36-yard line. Pick up a 4 on the play. I mean, there have been some hard hits in this one tonight, Tom Hunter.
Yes, there have. And Cabell Midland's defense bending, not breaking here, is they've been able to hold the Cougars' offense pretty much in check most of the second half. Big play here, third down and 5, as they need to get the ball back.
So head coach John Carpenter there, the pride of East Bank. Pratt keeps, pitches, turning the corner, Bays across the 40 to the 45 and up near midfield. They'll call him out at the 46-yard line for the first down pickup by Miguel Crunchy Bays of 10 yards, and it's a first down.
And a relatively quiet night so far for Bays, but reemerges at the right time for Capital, extending the drive, moving the chains, first down Cougars.
Ball at the 46. Pratt gives to Nazario, and Nazario slips away from defenders across the 50 into Cabell Midland territory at the 46.
Reminiscent of last week, Mark Martin, what we saw at South Charleston High School was John Carpenter in a tight ball game with an advantage, looking to grind it out on the ground, run some clock, keep his offense on the field and in control.
Gain of 9, second and 1. Stacked receivers, bottom of your screen, and to the top. Pratt felt the pressure from Reese Donahue. Pratt still on his feet and finally taken down, and there you have it. But Joe Stevens talked about earlier, you have Reese Donahue tackling Tyree Pratt. Two WVU Mountaineers down the road.
Austin Ellis that time. Pratt would have really been in trouble, but Ellis was able to come back on a block there late to free him up, to at least give him some positive yardage and get him back close to the line of scrimmage, third down and 5.
Harris will snap from midfield. Pratt hands it to Nazario, grinding to the 48. Stop made by Dustin Balk, the outside linebacker. They call that a bandit, and there's Nazario. What a tough little football player he is. You know, Luke Salmon's on the far side of the field. He does have the one fashion statement, the Crocs.
Yeah, he does.
He is well known for the Croc. And You know how tough he is. He wore the Crocs
from August to December.
Wore it at Wheeling Island Stadium. Fourth and three. And John Carpenter will call a timeout. We'll keep it here. We were talking about Coach Carpenter being the pride of East Bank, and John enjoyed some great years there for the Pioneers, and of course the school that produced the great Jerry West and Chris Massey. I think is maybe one of the most wonderful stories out of East Bank, and was a walk-on at Marshall, didn't look like it was going to work out. Bob Pruitt convinced him to stay, becomes a long snapper, has a phenomenal career, makes it into the NFL for 10 years. He'll go into Marshall's Hall of Fame here in a few weeks. So you see the silver and blue clad Cougars and their great cheering section here. Tom Hunter, and well, I tell you what, the juices are flowing with football again at Capital High School, a championship program with the great Roger Jefferson and of course John Carpenter adding that fourth a year ago.
We talked about Mo Townsend and the great tradition, this coaching fraternity at Capital, and what they've been able to do and making that memorable trip to Wheeling last year, coming home with the championship hardware, and certainly has energized the fan base up off Greenbrier Street at Capital High School, and they turn out here tonight to support their Cougars in their home field at Laidley Field, UC Stadium.
Fourth and three from the 48. Roger Jefferson had the program for 17 seasons, and then Mo Townsend. Of course, Mo had won championships at Stonewall. And then after Mo left the program, the late Jack Woolwine, Capitals season opener, the win over Riverside. That was the Jack Woolwine Memorial game won by the Cougars. And now John Carpenter runs the show. Fourth and three, and Pratt will kick it. Up high, bounces. This is up here saying, don't touch it, don't touch it, and good advice. Because when they said that, it was at the 15, they mark it down at the 9.
39 yards on the punt. And a nice roll for Pratt that time, and Capital accomplishing what they wanted out of that punting situation. That's the pin Midland down, forced him to work pretty much the length of the field to try to tie things up here. 14-7 advantage for the number one Capital Cougars.
Devin Stapleton, had the first touchdown.
Devin Stapleton struck that, and then it was Capital ever since. Tyree Pratt, explosive offense.
Tyler Brown has his pass batted down by Chris Harris. A look at the games. Last year, of course, was the great 35-28, the seven-pointed margin, seven at the moment in favor of Capital, 35-26 in 2013, 21-13 in 2012, a two-point game in 2011, 31-29. Capital did win by 20, 23-3 in 2010, which was the season opener, but then Midland took a four-point win in 2009. Brown launching, looking, and Humphrey running into the defender, which is Anthony Pittman, who's been playing here, and the ball falls incomplete. In 2008, Capital won 21-7, 17-10 in 07, and 28-27 in 06. So a 20-point win in 2010, a 14-point win in 08, and since then games have been decided by 9, 8, 7 twice, 4, 2, and 1. Some pretty good games in this series. Third down and 10. Brown under center. They set up and he's taken down by number 10, junior Teron Rush. John Carpenter says just a physical specimen, and he takes down Brown there. So the Knights will punt it away and will have to do so from their own end zone, trailing here by 7. Capital going to get the football back and should have great field position. There's Nazario standing at his 38. Humphrey. Ball hits at the 30. It's going to take a favorable bounce for Capital. Going to be down, let's see if they spot it at the 28-yard line. Catching it on the bounce for Cabell Midland was Hunter Hicks. So the Cougars here with a 7-point lead and perhaps a chance to add to it again. Second quarter is when all the scoring took place. Devin Stapleton, a 43-yard run. Came to Tinton, 46 mark. Then Nazario, a short 5-yard run at the 6:03 mark. And then at the 3:11 mark, Nazario raced 55 yards for the score. Here is the snap, and Pratt falls on it at the 40. Not at all ready for that.
Lucky that time to get on top of that football. So set up prime position here to cash one in, and now a little bit more work to do with the loss on that play. Takes it back, second down, 22.
John Carpenter. Kids love him. Now, if you come over and see me, don't be afraid to bring a jar of peanut butter. They like to have that peanut butter and jelly as they await the conclusion of the University of Charleston practices every day. UC going for its second win of the season tomorrow will be a tall task as they journey to Shepherdstown to play the Shepherd Rams. And Pratt will go down. And who takes him down but his future teammate in Morgantown, Reese Donahue. You like peanut butter?
I love it. Peanut butter's a hit at our house.
Yeah, I love it.
Particularly with Dexter and Dewey, the Yellow Lab and the Border Collie. They really like the peanut butter. It's a mandatory thing. When the lunch sandwiches get made in the morning, the dogs get a sandwich too.
There's Schaefer warming up on the sideline. All right, now they reset the play clock, and we're ready to go here on third and 24. And now whistles again. Going, don't forget, next week, Cabell Midland at home to face off with the Beckley Woodrow Wilson Flying Eagles. And we will be at Knights Stadium for that football game. And Knights Stadium last Saturday evening, Tom Hunter, was the scene of a nighttime cross-country meet.
1,700 runners Chris Parsons hosted there. Used diesel-powered light standards to light the course. The last races start at 10:30. Great event for the Knights cross-country program.
Pratt being pursued, and Pratt lets it fly, and it goes out of bounds. And, well, we've got a flag here, and I'm curious to see if Doug Spry feels that maybe Cabell Midland gave a shove to Pratt a little too late. Nope. Going to go against Capital.
Well, John Carpenter.
Now say intentional grounding against Pratt. That's the call. And, Pratt was coming, and I probably he was wanting to go out of bounds. But I don't know if he thought he saw something, but officials don't see it that way. So Connor Reeves, well, he had a beautiful punt earlier in this second half. So Capital will kick it away, and Cabell Midland going to get another opportunity here. Reeves, boy, and it's blocked. It is blocked by Reese Donahue, and Cabell Midland has the football at the Capital 32. Reese Donahue got in there and blocks the punt.
What a momentum shift here potentially for Midland. They've set themselves up with a golden opportunity here. 5:52 left to go in this ball game. And with the special teams standout performance of the night there, Reese Donahue and the Cabell Midland Knights see what they can do on offense.
And a great camera work by our crew here. The pitch to Humphrey. He'll look to turn the corner. Taken down. Nice open field tackle there made by James Knox, the senior. 5'10", 162. Second down and 10.
Over for instruction from Luke Sammons. Sammons going to work some clock here. Be very methodical in his approach on this drive.
High formation. And keeping the football is Brown. Brown slipping away. Beautiful ball faking by Brown. Moving the chains. Taking it to the 19-yard line. See if they spot it at the 20. Just inside the 20, gain of 12, first down. We move the chains, presented by the West Virginia Oil and Gas Association, celebrating 100 years. Hendricks in motion, gets the handoff. Hendricks at the 15, 10, staggers, diving for the end zone, and will be stopped at the 1. A 19-yard gain by Hendricks on the near side. We do have a flag down back at the 24-yard line, and that nifty piece of running by Hendricks is going to come back.
This is a great run, great spin move, way to get into the open field, and the second effort there trying to get the pylon.
Well, Tom, we've been together 2 weeks and two great games.
Yeah.
Let's just keep it going.
Well, we got to keep us going. We've had two dandies. Last week, the 26-21 victory for the Cougars over South Charleston. In a raucous environment at South Charleston High School. And what we expected tonight, a dogfight between Midland and Capital.
The ball goes back to the 33, and now we have ball start by the Knights. Now, suddenly, it's Sam's crew, back-to-back penalties. High school football in the great state of West Virginia. Now, again, it's still early. We do want to touch upon today, 9/11. And that changed all of our lives forever.
Certainly.
Think about the families.
Chris Gray,
from
WVU quarterback, was lost in that tragedy at the World Trade Center.
A pitch, Stapleton across the 25, 35, down to the 30.
Late flag.
And we're going to have flags coming out.
Late hit, and that was, appeared to be helmet to helmet, coming in late on the play. Yeah. So
Etheridge made the stop. Stapleton takes it from the 39.
And still down on the ground is, looks like Stapleton, and he is in pain. See him there in the bottom right corner of the shot being tended to by the Midland training staff. Of course, a lot of that training staff from the Jones C. Edwards School of Medicine at Marshall University. And personal foul will be assessed against the Capital Cougars.
Well, the penalties had been hurting Cabell Midland, and now they're going to get to take advantage of a penalty. But going back to 9/11, and again, so many lost, so many lives lost, and so many families and friends, lives changed forever. This country changed forever. And again, from a standpoint of athletics here in West Virginia, you mentioned Chris Gray, the former Mountaineer quarterback, and also there in Parkersburg, the Mary Lou Haig Sports Complex, named for that beautiful young lady.
Parkersburg who was a high school graduate.
Yeah, Parkersburg Red Wing, and went to the University of North Carolina, and her dream was always to work in New York City, and just a lovely young lady from what we have been told, and you can see what that community thought of her to name that athletic complex in her honor.
And from the Marshall University community, yes. Dr. Paul Ambrose, yeah. I was a member of the Marshall staff at that time, and tragedy to this day very deeply affects the Marshall University community, and he was such a public health advocate, was really an up-and-comer, working closely with the Surgeon General of the United States, and we'll never forget those lives that were impacted on that tragic day in this country.
Humphrey gets the handoff, and Humphrey goes inside the 10, down to the 7-yard line. Mac Payton will put the stop on Humphrey. Move the Chains, presented by the West Virginia Oil and Gas Association, celebrating 100 years. First and goal to go for the 8. Humphrey just keeps churning, doesn't he?
Flag down on the, looks like the 2-yard line, middle of the field.
Knox made the stop, number 12 for the Cougars.
Scores rolling in on the Twitter feed from My Witness News at WCHS 8 Fox 11. There's the Friday Night Football Extra scoreboard. You can check those out on Twitter at that Twitter handle. And coming up, what, about 90 minutes? Just a few short blocks down Piedmont Road. You're going to be rejoining your colleagues. And
yeah, my buddies Josh and Kenny and all of our gang over there. We have a great time.
Tune in 11:15 on WCHS-TV8 for Mark and the gang for Friday Night Football Extra.
See the calls there, Tom. Personal fouls, the offsetting penalties. Wow. Spring Valley knocking off South Charleston tonight. Donnie Mays' crew suddenly 1-2 on the season. Did not see that one coming.
Well, Fred Crozier losing him and him being out at least till, from what we're hearing, the end of the regular season. Big loss for the Black Eagles.
Big win for Brad Dingus and the Timberwolves. Humphrey with the handoff. Humphrey takes people into the end zone. Did he score? He did. Touchdown, Cabell Midland.
What a run.
Well, he's 15 to 20 pounds heavier. Look at him, just chiseled speed. Not going to come down easily. Across the way, the Knight fans on this beautiful September night. Gonna see if their team can tie it up. Molina's kick up. Molina's kick is good. We're tied at 14. We will return to UC Stadium in a moment here on WCHSTV.com.
What looks good? Ooh, lobster bisque.
That actually does sound
nice.
Really good.
I want everything on here. Serious.
Okay, this is the third one.
Weird.
Keep tabs on your home, even control it, with the all-new Suddenlink Connected Home, the easy way for peace of mind.
We should probably get home.
Yeah.
At Hurricane Trophy, we offer a complete line of traditional trophies, resin awards, and acrylics, along with the area's finest assortment of engraved plaques and beautiful corporate gifts. Our apparel selection is second to none, and year after year, our embroidery services come in at unbeatable prices. Give us a call or stop in today.
There is the time remaining here at UC Stadium. Historically filled at UC Stadium. This venue was reconstructed back in 1979. The first ever game, the North-South All-Star football game, a guy by the name of Kurt Warner out of Pineville, West Virginia, was the star of the night. On the squib kick, Capital will have the football, and Warner, he was the Kennedy Award winner, but he came from tiny school in Wyoming County, and some folks wondered about him. You know, single A football. Well, he proved himself that night, and he went on to prove himself.
I say Joe Paterno didn't wonder about him. He wondered how he could get him to State College, and he managed to get him up there.
When he went and watched him play basketball, and of course, he had just a wonderful career, and then on to the NFL, now in the College Football Hall of Fame. And that's how it all got started here in this great football venues and state championship games and great high school games, and we've got a great one right here. We've got some pretty good backs in this game as well, and Nazario and Stapleton and Humphreys. We're tied at 14. Capital in the attack, and Nazario zigs and zags, brought down by Reese Donahue.
and the Zarios had a great night. You see number one out there. And these are the types of moments that have defined a resume for that young man. The leader of this Capital Cougars ball club, Tyree Pratt. Crunch time, tie ball game. I can't think of too many other quarterbacks in this state, Mark, right now in West Virginia prep football that you'd want out there in this situation than Tyree Pratt.
Yeah. He has been something special. And, you know, coaches talk about getting an opportunity to guide young men such as Pratt. And I just think in our profession, just the pleasure we have to cover these kids and, you know, just not the great players, but just the young men in general. It's our pleasure, and, boy, it's been a lot of fun here tonight, and we hope to have many more like this in 2015 on our Friday Night Football Game of the Week presented by the West Virginia Federal Credit Union. So Pratt and company go back to work here now, second and six.
Looking over, seeing what John Carpenter is going to do, if he's going to.
Well, they're trying to get the
they are
clock set
the clock
here.
Out. Yeah.
3:35.
Clock was at 3:46. It takes it to 3:35. You get every set, and they wind it. Clock rolling. So we approach 3.5 minutes left to go late. The tie ball game.
Pratt sets up, guns it. Martin, incomplete.
Another beautiful throw. Just Martin pulled up that time on the route to wait for a minute. You don't wait on Tyree Pratt. He's going to deliver the football. You've got to get yourself downfield, and that little bit of hesitation might have cost him there.
Now, Martin caught both South Charleston and Cabell Midland's attention with what he did in game one. They've silenced that young man the past couple of weeks here. We will be hearing a lot from number four over the next few years. Well, we have another flag down. Sideline warning against the Knights. A few sideline issues in this game, haven't we? Somebody left.
Somebody that wasn't even part of the Capital program was escorted out of here because of a sideline issue. Maybe watching our telecast right now.
Pratt fires it out. A great job there by Martin, just keeping his concentration. It bounced off of his pads and in the air, and he grabbed it, but Capital will have to give it up. Atkins is the punter for the Cougars. Stapleton and Humphrey back deep. Line driver, Stapleton going to take it at the 31. Across the 35, spins away, still spinning, and finally goes down at the 37-yard line. Another flag down. Another flag comes out. We're going to have a block in the back here.
Yeah.
Wade McNabb made the stop there for Capital. Well, no one has left, and rightfully so.
Well, they got their money's worth this evening,
oh,
I'll
my.
Tell you.
Got their money's worth. Hopefully got their popcorn, their corn dogs, their hot dogs, their calzones, their lemonade.
Their lemonades. We didn't get the lemonade, man, I'm telling you.
You know, there's some great food to be had here at all venues across the area, but quite good here at UC Stadium. This game has been special, and speaking of special, Caperton Humphrey has had a big night, and he travels from the 27-yard line. Over there, sideline 34. Gained 7 on the play. Second down and 3.
Approaching the 2-minute mark.
Love being up here around the coaches. We're high above here at UC Stadium. And, you know, think about the coaches on the field, boy. It's just as nerve-wracking up here. Great fake by Brown. He's got the first down and more as he takes it to the 47-yard line.
Stop the time to reset the chains. It looked like Brown was able to keep in bounds there. Might have been driven out. It'll be interesting to see if they roll the clock here once the chains are reset.
Jordan McCormick made the stop. Moving the chains, presented by the West Virginia Oil and Gas Association, celebrating 100 years. Brown fakes again. Brown keeps, and Brown into Capital territory.
They stop the clock again. Looks like they drove him out of bounds. If you're Luke Sammons, you want to get those kids to get down in bounds, keep this clock rolling right now. Force gain. Capital to use those timeouts.
Pardon me, Tom, gain of 6. Second and 4, and boy, Brown getting his chance to lead here. Young man, you know you're a senior, and you wait your turn, and he's been impressive in those 2 blowout wins, and here he is battling one of the best teams in the state. Devin Stapleton gets it to the 45-yard line. We're going to spot him at the 44, and McCormick, third down and 1. McCormick makes the stop.
Talk about fans getting their money's worth here tonight, Mark. And make it some extra football. Great, we're going 14-14 tie. Midland looking to get it here.
Brown keeps it. Gets the first down. Etheridge takes him out. How about Brown here down the stretch running the football?
Nice job at running that option offense. Take control here late. You know, like we've said several times through the broadcast, he doesn't play like a first-year starter. He certainly hasn't shown it here down the stretch.
Hendricks in motion. Stapleton to his right. Stapleton finds a seam, and Stapleton has the first down. Still going. Stapleton going to take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Cabell Midland.
What an effort. What an effort by Stapleton. Second, third, fourth effort finally finds pay dirt. Big score for Midland.
41 yards. Devin Stapleton.
Wow. What a run.
2 TD runs tonight. Molina up and good. We will keep it right here. Stapleton, a 43-yarder in the second quarter. That picture of John Carpenter tells it all, but his team still with time showing on that clock, and with number 1 and number 5 and number 15, number 4, you got to like your chances.
Don't count them out.
Look at that Midland sideline. The lone loss a season ago was to this Capital team. Well, they reached the playoffs and got eliminated in the second round by Huntington, a team they had beaten during the regular season. Luke Sammons loves football, loves coaching. What an athlete he was at Ravenswood High School. He just wasn't a football player. An all-state pitcher. He was a state champion wrestler. Still solid as a rock. All right, Molina will kick it off. And scooped up This is McNabb at the 32 and taken down. Stopped there by Camp.
Capital with two timeouts left. And like I mentioned during that Midland series, if you're Luke Sammons, you probably wanted your quarterback to get down and bounce to try to force John Carper to burn one of the, at least one of those two timeouts. Now he has two timeouts in his pocket. He's got an experienced quarterback and speed on the outside receivers. They can work those outside routes and get upfield. They got some time to work with here. You know, dangerous weapons in this Capital Cougars backfield. Let's see what they can do and see if number one and defending champ Capital can pull themselves off the mat here late and tie this thing up.
Pratt. Throws, fires, incomplete. Luke Salmon said, we're going to come up here, we're going to have fun. We're going to play football and have fun. And it's been a fun game to follow. Concern showing there on the Capital fans. See if they have magic here to get this thing even. With 34 seconds to go. Goldsmith comes wide to the bottom of your screen. Pratt fires it out. Nazario, the screen. Nazario slowed up and slung to the turf. Outstanding play made there by Isaiah Duncan.
Capital takes a quick timeout.
We'll keep it here. The Cougars. Now facing third down.
John Carpenter regrouping with his troops here on the sideline. Going to give him a series of some plays here.
You know, like John said, you know, these are the kind of games you want to coach.
Absolutely.
This is what you get into this for. And he's enjoyed some good times here in the past few years, as has Luke Sammons and his crew. These are just two great high school football programs, regardless of what happens here. In the final 22.7, you'll be hearing a lot from these two, but we're not done. Pratt steps up, launches, and cannot get it into the hands of Crunchy Bays.
And before the snap, you could hear the Midland defensive coaches up here in the box with us yelling, timeout, timeout, timeout. They saw something in what Tyree Pratt brought to the line that they didn't like in the matchups. They wanted to burn a timeout there. Fortunately, incomplete pass for them. They didn't have to waste the timeout. And we're down to fourth down. And a last shot here for Tyree Pratt with 16 ticks of the clock to go. What a game, Mark. What a game.
Here we go. Pratt looks, launches, looking for Martin, and no chance. Good coverage by Ray. And it's an incomplete pass, and Midland is going to take over. And with just eight ticks left, and Luke Sammons, he's had a lot of big wins at Cabell Midland, and this one's going to rank right up there. And don't forget, take a quick break. We will present our Smart 529 player of the game and also present our Hurricane Trophy Champions of the Game award. The Knights take over at the Capital 32. Get in that victory formation. Brown on a knee, and this one is over. The Capital Cougars and the Cabell Midland Knights. What a show here at UC Stadium, and the Knights win it 21-14. Back in a moment here on WCHSTV.com.
You You'll score big when you give West Virginia Federal Credit Union the opportunity to earn your business. West Virginia Federal Credit Union is your community credit union with the goal of building deposit and loan relationships, not just opening accounts. They offer the highest level of service for every member every day and feature a no annual fee debit card that offers cash rewards and surcharge-free ATM access at over 50 locations in the Charleston-Huntington area. It's time to get on the team that has the best game plan. West Virginia Federal Credit Union. Together we all win.
Carver Career and Technical Center specializes in helping you reach your career goals, offering certificate and short-term education programs designed to prepare both secondary students and adult learners for employment. Don't put off your future another day. Contact Carver Career and Technical Center today.
I'm here with West Virginia Assistant State Treasurer Josh Stowers to talk about the Smart 529 College.
All right, let's take it down as Cabell Midland wins over Capital here. Great game. Joe Stevens standing by with our Smart 529 player of the game. Joe?
Devin Stapleton, what a great game. Great high school contest. Tell us about those last 4 minutes there.
Well, we trained every day for that moment right there, so I knew I had to get down to it when it came to it.
Now, do you think being able to go you were one of the few players on Cabell Midland tonight to go both ways.
Yeah.
Were you ready for the end there?
Yes, sir. We've been having me flop both ways at practice and just getting physically there, mentally ready for it.
So you got scores tied, 14-14. Your numbers called in the huddle. What were you thinking?
I was thinking I just got to do this for my team because I believe in them and I want them to believe in me. So.
Okay, you knock off number one in the state.
Yes,
who's
sir.
Number one now?
I guess that makes us number one, huh?
There you go. Congratulations.
Thank you, sir.
Devin Stapleton, our College 529 player of the game here on WCHSTV.com.
All right, Joe Stevens, great job. And we will present our Hurricane Trophy champions of the game as we get set to talk with the winning head coach of the Cabell Midland Knights, Luke Sammons, and then we'll bid you adieu here tonight, but just your thoughts.
Impressive outing by Midland. You know, Mark, we've been hearing whispers. You've heard them on the trail, preseason trail, talking to the coaches that they felt like the surprise team at AAA could be these Midland Knights. They're certainly not a surprise anymore. Luke Sammons proving this ball club is very legitimate.
Yeah.
A title contender early in the season in Class AAA. With Joe Stevens will be catching up.
Oh,
Sammons,
right here.
Luke's talking with his was going over to talk to his ball club. Now he's going to catch up here with Joe. But again, Midland's for real. Capital, nothing to be ashamed of. And honestly, this could be a good reality check for John Carpenter's ball club. After the highs of Wheeling and all the preseason hype, we're going to throw it down now to Joe Stevens. Joe with our winning head coach, Luke Sammons, Cabell Midland.
Coach, one heck of a high school football game.
Yeah, they're a great team. Hats off to our kids. They answered the call in the second half. Defense played great all night. Coaches did good. Offense really started moving the ball. We went through some things, but they answered, and that's what a good team does. So, but hats off to Capital. They're a great team as well.
Coach, last 4 minutes, things just started clicking for you?
Yeah, we started moving the ball. Defense was great all night, like I said, but, we got a few breaks, and we got good field position, and we needed that, and we punched it in.
What did you tell your guys at halftime, down 14-7?
That's who we are. We work all year. We work all summer. We've got great, tough kids, good coaches. It's just a mindset, toughness and finish what you started. So they picked it up in the second half.
3-0, coach, early in the season. You got a heck of a team here.
Yeah, we got to keep getting better. It's not, it's a big win for our program, coaches, players, community. But the bottom line is it's week three and we got 10, seven more games. So we got to continue to work. But anytime you beat Capital, at Capital, that's a great win for our program, so we'll enjoy it.
Well, Coach, on behalf of WCHSTV.com, our game of the week, here's your trophy. Show you the guys.
All right, Joe Stevens, great job. Our Hurricane Trophy, champions of the game trophy to the Cabell Midland Knights. We'll see the Knights next week as well as they take on Beckley Woodrow Wilson, 21-14.
Luke Sammons' crew winning over the Capital Cougars here tonight. A great high school football game. We'll be hearing a lot from these teams throughout the season. Tom Hunter, great job here tonight, my friend.
Great to be back with you. I'll see you here in a couple weeks. I'm going to go back to Ripley and tend to the Vikings duties next week. But another barn burner next week, potentially. We'll see.
All right. Tom Hunter with us here, Joe Stevens, and we thank all of you for joining us here tonight and our wonderful crew. I'm Mark Martin. We say so long from UC Stadium here in Charleston, and the Knights of Cabell Midland knock off the Capital Cougars by a final score of 21-14 on our Friday night football game of the week, presented by the West Virginia Federal Credit Union.
Building a garage? Remodeling both bathrooms? Adding another bedroom? When you need cash for home improvements, a college education, or a dream vacation, a West Virginia Federal Credit Union home equity line of credit is the answer. Experience the credit union difference at West Virginia Federal Credit Union. No annual fee, no origination fee, no closing costs, and rates among the best in town. All loans subject to credit and underwriting approval. Contact West Virginia Federal Credit Union for details about credit loans and terms. Let West Virginia Federal Credit Union earn your business.
No matter what you're looking for, Thornhill Auto Group does it best. Thornhill GM Superstore.
I'm here with West Virginia Assistant State Treasurer Josh Stowers to talk about the Smart 529 College Savings Program. Josh, we're here with high school students today who are almost ready to go to college. Many of these kids out on the field are seniors, so the big question is high school too late to open up a college savings account?
Absolutely not, Joe. It's never too late to start saving for college. Obviously, the earlier you can start saving for college, the better. It means the less you have to take out in loans. But one of the big advantages of the Smart 529 College Savings Plan is the tax advantages, regardless of when you start to save. The state income tax deduction that you'll receive is a huge advantage, and that money also accumulates, your investments accumulate over time, tax deferred from your federal income taxes. So those are advantages that regardless of when you start saving, you can take advantage of.
How do you know how much to save?
Well, clearly we don't know how much college is going to cost 18 years from now, but we do know that those costs are outpacing inflation and rising every year. And we have a tool on our website, smart529.com, a college savings calculator that will give you a good estimate of how much those costs are going to be when your child is ready for college. And it also gives you some tools to learn about how to start saving for those costs. We have them on our website, wvtreasury.com. You can also go to our social media sites, search WV Treasury on Twitter and Facebook to find out more about those tools and how to start saving for your child's education.
One more time, the website address.
WVTreasury.com, also smart529.com.
Thanks, Josh, for joining us during the halftime here.
Thanks, Joe. Appreciate it.